Hi, I'm Pastor Dennis Pruitt. Be sure to watch Our Town Williamsburg Thursday, September the 12th at 8 on WPSU.
Station WPSU. I'm Whitney Sheridan along with Jessica Peters, and it's your night, Williamsburg. It's the premiere of Our Town Williamsburg. Stories told by your friends and neighbors. In fact, they're here in the WPSU studios. They have made the trip to our studios to share their stories about your hometown, right, Jessica?
That's right. We are going to see so many stories from the Williamsburg area tonight. We're going to learn about the park. We're going to go inside Charlie Hauser's barbershop. We are going to go to the American Legion. We're going to learn about all the great community services that they provide. And we're going to show our Blue Pirate Pride tonight.
That's right.
Right here on WPSU.
Blue Pirate Pride. Blue Pirate Pride. That's right. We are so excited. Make sure everyone you know is watching because it's your night, Williamsburg. Tell everyone to watch online if they're out of the area, WPSU.org, or tune into Channel 3 if you're in Central PA. Get ready. Williamsburg coming your way right now.
Hi, I'm Ted Howe, Mayor of Williamsburg, and welcome to Our Town.
Welcome to Williamsburg, Pennsylvania. The oldest borough in Blair County in the heart of Morrison's Cove, this is a town founded around the Big Spring and a community that celebrates its Blue Pirate Pride. Join us as local residents show and tell everything that makes their community a great hometown. Your friends and neighbors welcome you to Our Town, Williamsburg. Support for Our Town, Williamsburg comes from UPMC Altoona, Williamsburg Family Practice, providing care for the whole family, including obstetrics. Information at 832-3405. Mill Hill Farm Supply, servicing the Williamsburg community since 1980. Information at millhillag.com. Penn England LLC, 10341 Fox Run Road, a proud sponsor of Our Town Williamsburg. Information at 832-2776. Williamsburg Borough, small town, big history. Information at williamsburgpennsylvania.com. The Williamsburg Community School District, where students learn with excitement and are given the opportunity to succeed in a changing world and become positive contributors to a changing society. More information at williamsburg.k12.pa.us. The Williamsburg Community Betterment Corporation, helping businesses in the Williamsburg area and a proud supporter of Our Town Williamsburg. And from viewers like you, thank you.
Hi, I'm Bill Brantner. I'm the former mayor here in Williamsburg, and I want to talk a little bit about the founder of our town and a few influential or pretty prominent people from our town. Jacob Ake was the founder. He founded our town in 1790. Jacob Ake bought 600 acres originally, and then he subdivided it. 317 acres is here in the borough. There was originally 120 lots when the town was first organized. Originally, it was called Ake Town, and in 1820, he renamed the town after his son, William. And the reason he chose Williamsburg was because of the ample water supply, because of the Big Spring. And there's approximately 6 million gallon a day, and it goes down the race into the Juniata River. Two of the most famous people, probably from Williamsburg, would be Charles Schwab and Wilmer Stultz. Charles Schwab was probably one of the wealthiest men back in that time, back in early 1900s. He was right up there with the Carnegies and the Vanderbilts and the Rockefellers. He was born here in Williamsburg and had a lot of close friends here, a lot of town's elders, and he told them that whenever Williamsburg decides to industrialize, he would come back, and he kept his word. In 1905, he secured $1 million to break ground for the paper mill. And the paper mill was here for approximately 70, 75 years, and it created a lot of jobs. Wilmer Stultz was a guy that flew the plane. It was called the Friendship. He flew it across the Atlantic. It was the first transcontinental flight recorded. and his passengers was Amelia Earhart and Lou Gordon. They had a big celebration here in Williamsburg whenever he returned home. Unfortunately, he died at a young age in a plane accident. His plane went down in Roosevelt Field in Long Island in 1929. He's buried here in Williamsburg over at the Presbyterian Cemetery, and unless you really knew where to look for the grave, it's just a small, simple tombstone buried beside his wife, Mildred. There's a bronze plaque on the flat surface of the grave that says that he's the one that flew the Friendship. I think the borough is very proud of the fact that we've always tried to keep that part of our history, our heritage, for many generations to see. I've done everything humanly possible to make sure that there's always going to be a record somewhere of all the heritage. Williamsburg's a small town, but it's got a big heart. And any time there's been a tragedy in our town, or the people just seem to pull together. The small town atmosphere, I guess, is what I enjoy most. And I've been fortunate enough to be all over the world, but it's always nice to come back to my hometown.
Hi, I'm Rebecca Mangle, and I'm here to talk to you about the story of Riverside Park. When I was very young, there was a trailer court, a lot of homes down there. There was a flood. That flood was in 1972. And after that, it was just kind of a devastation. In 1978, the borough acquired that land, and they decided that it would be nice to put in a playground. And it was well used for many, many years. It was okay, but it wasn't colorful. Like, it wouldn't make a child be like, oh, let's go to the playground. So I went to borough council and I said, we need a playground. We need a place that's gonna be colorful and vibrant for kids, and parents can come and kind of get that spirit back that we had when we were kids. And they said, sure, but we don't have any money for you. At the time, I worked in the Blair County Human Services office and I was the community mobilizer. And one day a grant from DCNR came down. And I was like, oh, wow, this is pretty interesting. I wonder if this is something that we could do. I knew I had to give it a shot because my son was my driving force. We submitted it and we got accepted. And that grant was for $60,000. However, you had to have $15,000 in cash match. So we just started doing some little things like cans in the pharmacy, cans in the grocery stores. The United Way has impact funding every year. And then we also had a small Rotary grant. We had a community donation of $20,000 from someone, which was outstanding, and I'll never forget that day on the telephone. You know, I just cried and cried, but it was the best day ever. We had our build day in 2007, in July. And they showed up one morning, and he's like, okay, I'm here, and the playground will be done by tomorrow afternoon. And we were like, oh my goodness, how's this gonna happen? Sure enough, it did. Everything needed to make this happen, beside the pieces of equipment, was donated by all the people in the community. You're talking about gas, you're talking about manpower, you're talking about heavy equipment, you're talking, you know, just manual labor, everything. Now we have this playground, what are we gonna do? We have to really put it to use. So I wrote for a grant through Operation Our Town and received funding for a summer recreation program. We are now in our sixth year. We're self-sustaining. We have a 5K on the Rails to Trails every Memorial weekend. That's our biggest fundraiser. We have breakfast with Santa, lunch with the Easter Bunny, just some little things. You know, we want to make money to be able to sustain ourselves, but our mission from the beginning has always been, as long as we break even and don't lose money, let's do whatever we can do to have kids with their parents come together and do things as a community. But that's how it just all came about. It was a dream and a thought one day, and you know, and now my kids love it, and I think a lot of other people love it too.
My name is Don Appleman. I was born and raised in Williamsburg, lived here all my life, and I'm here to speak today on the legacy of sports in the community of Williamsburg, and specifically Williamsburg High School. We're probably best known for our basketball. I think if you go anywhere in the state of Pennsylvania and you say you're from Williamsburg, people will say that's the town with the good basketball teams. A school our size, we've had 8 players play at the Division I level, boys and girls, I think 4 of each. We've been to the state championship game 8 times, winning 3 of those, which at one point we ranked in the top 10 in the state, maybe still do, of state championship appearances. That's schools of all sizes. From 1955 until the present, we've had a tremendous run of successful basketball teams. I think in the last 95 basketball seasons, boys and girls together, we've had 88 winning seasons out of 95 seasons, which is incredible. Our girls program really didn't start, the modern program, until the mid-70s. Baseball really was here at the turn of the last century. I think people refer to it as town ball. All the area communities had baseball teams. Williamsburg was not an exception. We had very, very good baseball here. We have started a girls softball program. It's a little less than 10 years old just this year. They made the playoffs for the first time. Football tradition here at Williamsburg started, first high school team was in 1925. We've had 88 years continuously of high school football. Over those years, I believe we've had 6 undefeated football teams. Right now, we're the smallest school in the state with a football team. We graduate around anywhere from 35 to 40 students top. So it's tough to compete in football, but we've done very, very well. And the school is really a big part, sort of the core of our community. I've been part of the school district here for the past 45 years. I wouldn't have traded that for anything in the world. This is where I wanted to be, and I think most people would say the same thing that I'm saying, that if they had a choice to live anywhere in the world, they would have picked Williamsburg. It's a great place to grow up, a great place to be an athlete, play sports, to coach, to teach. It's been a lot of fun. It's really been nice to be part of that.
My name is Charles Hauser. I'm the town barber. I've been in the barbershop for 54 years, and I know a little bit about the town. Shop is approximately 125 years old, and I'm the third barber in 125 years. The man before me was there for 45 years, and of course I've been there 55 years now, and the man before, I didn't know who he was.
The original roof's still on this barbershop. That's about all.
Started in the 9th grade in school. During the Second World War, the barbershop that I went to was right down the corner from where we live. Well, his man went to the Navy. So he came up to the house and said to my mother, "You think he'd like to be a barber?" "Yes, he'd like to be a barber." She didn't even ask me. And that's how long I've been cutting hair. And I'll be 85 next month. And the barbershop is completely the same as it was 125 years ago. And I had a good experience 2 years ago. This big car pulls up in front of the barbershop, and I had never seen a live chauffeur. And the chauffeur got out of the car and got this little old lady out. And she came in and she said, "I'm 90 years old, and my grandfather had planted this tree in front of the barbershop. There was a big tree there." And she said, "I wanted to make a trip back and see if the tree was still there." She stopped dead in the barbershop, looked around, and she said, "Hasn't changed a bit."
The shampoo was 1/4. Trimming the beard was 10 cents. Hair tonic was 15 cents.
It's a nice place, and I'm blessed with fine customers. Most of my customers today are older people. They have a lot of loafers in the morning. When they open the barbershop, they come and we shoot the bull and discuss the world topics. They love to reminisce about the paper mill and what used to be here, and it's a good place, and I've been very happy there. The people here are extremely nice. Like, if something breaks in the barbershop, one of the men will fix it. You find that camaraderie with our people, and that means a great deal. To me, it does anyway. It's just a nice place to live. It's a quiet place. You can still take a walk at night. Nobody's going to bop you over the head or anything. So, and I've talked to a couple of my customers that moved away, young people that got jobs elsewhere. They didn't like living in Williamsburg. Well, they found out when they went on the other side of the mountains, it was a whole different world. 9 out of 10 people are very happy here, and when they're happy, we're all happy.
My name's Carl King. I'm the Vice President of Rails to Trails of Central Pennsylvania, and we own and operate the Lower Trail, which passes through Williamsburg. It's about 17 miles long, and it's available free of charge to the public for bicycling, running, horseback riding, bird watching, any number of activities along the trail. We opened the trail in 1992. It was named for the late wife and son of attorney T. Dean Lauer, who is one of our largest benefactors. It is the Lauer Trail as opposed to the Lower Trail. Everybody wonders where the Upper Trail is, but it's pronounced Lauer because of the family name. The trail is built along the old Petersburg branch of the Pennsylvania Railroad, and the Petersburg branch was actually built along the corridor of the mainline canal, the Pennsylvania mainline canal. So there are a lot of historic artifacts along the way. You can find ruins of lock tenders' houses. You can find ruins of canal locks. The trail passes through mostly wooded areas right along the Frankstown branch of the Juniata River, so there is an opportunity for a lot of wildlife. We've seen deer and turtles and mostly rabbits and squirrels. Bear have been seen, and bald eagles have been spotted along the trail, so it's kind of an eclectic variety of wildlife that you can see along the trail. All of the mowing and the tree removal when trees get knocked down by storms, everything is done by a small group of really dedicated volunteers who go out and take care of the trail and maintain it. The most scenic times are obviously in the spring when the red buds are in bloom, and in the fall when the leaves are turning, but it's also very beautiful in the wintertime for cross-country skiing, and in the summer when the trees are out and green and everything is beautiful and you ride along or walk along the river, and it's a very peaceful and enjoyable experience. It does bring a lot of folks into Williamsburg, and that's one of the reasons that we established the trail, to try to bring people from surrounding communities into this area. Williamsburg really has the only facilities to serve the trail riders. There are convenience stores and pizza shops and an ice cream stand right along the trail that provides great soft serve. And, so this is kind of a hub community for the trail. I think the community is very pleased with the trail. It provides a really nice opportunity for outdoor recreation, for families. Parents can take their kids out on the trails, not have to worry about traffic on bicycles or walking. People walk their dogs on the trails, and so it really gives an outlet for the community, as well as for visitors who come into the community and patronize some of the local shops.
Hi, I'm Shane Dixon, and I'm here to talk about Chad Emmonson and the tank in the corner of the Riverside Park. Chad Emmonson wanted to be in the military, and he loved the military and stuff, and he wanted to fight for our country, and he wanted to always be part of something bigger than what it was in the town. Chad's favorite saying was, "Freedom isn't free." He was killed in Operation Iraqi Freedom in 2009, and that memorial was just to remember him by what he did in the military and everything. There's a thing made out of bricks. It's like a big block, and there's two boots with a rifle in between it and a helmet on top. And there's a bench that has his name on there, and it says, "By the class of 2008. And there's a pavilion that has a soldier kneeling down in front of a cross. And he has his hand on top of the rifle. And he's looking down at the grave. We gave the cannon that used to be in the middle of town to the army so they can melt it down to use for tanks. And we got the tank in 1992 for us giving them the cannon to melt down. Park is a good place to have that memorial because there's lots of people there. There's always picnics down there and birthday parties, and the baseball field's always like having games and stuff. And there's always kids in that recreation is down there all the time. And they can all get together and celebrate the memorial and stuff there. Chad would have appreciated the memorial.
My name is Bill Lee. I'm here to represent the Williamsburg American Legion and the Williamsburg American Legion Home Association. The American Legion was constituted in 1919, and then we chartered our club in 1921. And the club was named after two World War I vets who are deceased, Bonner and Sullenberger. And this building that we have now was a township schoolhouse, and we purchased it in 1950. In later years, we decided to remodel the building and double the size of it. And coming into our building, there's paintings done by Woodlings Arts, and very, very nice. It's all military-oriented. It's all well-lighted. The American Legion's there to support veterans, of course. For example, we have veterans from the Hollidaysburg Veterans Home down three times a year. We treat them to a volunteer band, a catered meal, and when each one leaves, has a $10 bill in their bag. We do a lot for local veterans. We support every veteran organization in the area and some of the national ones. We do the Memorial Day Parade. We do the local cemeteries. And then we go out of town. We always select three graveyards to fire over the graves. And also, we always go first to the last departed veteran. We participate in most everything that goes on in the town. Coming into town, we maintain three flags. As you come into the town, a prisoner of war, the American flag, and Legion flag. We have a veterans memorial. We also have a veterans memorial park in the center of town as to where we generally end our parades. We raise funds through the American Legion Home Association, and the Home Association carries a license for Small Game of Chance. The funds from the Small Game of Chance goes to the Legion, and we support 32 charities of one sort or another annually. We support all the local Little League teams and football teams and baseball teams and horseshoe pitching. If we know a family's down and out, we try to help. The Legion means a lot to me. It's been my life. This is home. This is where I've left a few times, and I always come right back. So where it's a small town, and it's like all small towns, we can all get mad at each other anytime. But let something happen in this town, and the entire town's there to help you.
There's more to come as we take a walk through town with a look back at local history, check out the public library, and attend the biggest party Williamsburg's ever seen. Now, show your support for Williamsburg and WPSU by making a pledge. Thanks. Thanks so much for joining us for Williamsburg Night here on your local public TV station, WPSU. I'm Whitney Sherman. So happy that you could join us for your night celebrating stories from your hometown, Williamsburg. And we've got the storytellers and volunteers who helped make this whole show possible. It's their stories that you're seeing come to life on screen tonight. And we want you to be a part of it and help us celebrate by calling 1-800-245-9779 because your support makes programs like this possible. And when you give us a call, we would love to send you a copy of Our Town Williamsburg on DVD for your contribution of $75. And know that it's that contribution that makes programs like this possible, makes this show and these stories come to life on screen. A contribution of $120 gets you two of those DVDs. And I wanna let you know that there are some great bonus features on these DVDs that we're not able to share with you tonight. 1-800-245-9779. We want to hear from you tonight, Williamsburg. We're going to thank every single person who calls in. Also, be sure to follow us on Twitter. You can see the hashtag up there in the corner of your screen. And also, be sure to let everyone know who's out of town that they can watch tonight's show online during this live broadcast at WPSU.org. I'm joined in the studio by Greg Peterson.
That's right. It's wonderful when people watch us online at WPSU.org/live. Just a shortcut to it. And then we get calls from around the United States and people who've moved away from Williamsburg. And I think we're kind of like a little contest. Who's the farthest away who calls in and make a pledge? I'm Greg Peterson. Thank you much for tuning in. Coming up, we're going to be visiting the Clover Creek Cheese Cellar. We're going to go to the library. We're going to visit the schools and learn all about Blue Pirate Pride. But right now, we want you to show your pride in your public TV station when you call 800-245-9779. Or you can go online and make a pledge, too, at WPSU.org. When you get there, there's a little thing on the top that says contribute. Click there, and it'll take you through the whole process. Secure a server, and it's an easy way for you to get your DVD of the show you're watching tonight, Our Town Williamsburg, with extra bonus footage. That's $75. You can charge it on your Visa, MasterCard, American Express, or Discover. For $120, we can send you two copies. keep one for yourself, send one away to somebody, or keep it to give it away at Christmas time or whatever. Just our way of saying thanks. Now, as I look behind me, all the phones are kind of busy. So if you had trouble getting through, wait a minute or two, or go online at WPSU.org and make your pledge that way. The Our Town Project has been a great thing we've done since 1996. It really helps us connect with the communities we serve throughout all of central Pennsylvania, as far north as Bradford, as far south as Somerset, and all the places in between. So it's a large coverage area, and we wanted to do something that would connect us with those communities. And the Our Town Project has been a great way for us to make new friends and new members. 800-245-9779. Call right now with your pledge. Oh, Jessica.
Hello, my name is Jessica Peters. Thanks so much for joining us tonight. All of the phones are busy right now, but you can go online to WPSU.org to make your contribution tonight. And remember, with that contribution of $75, we will send you a copy of tonight's program, Our Town Williamsburg, with special bonus features that include something from Dorothy Koontz, from Bill Kramer, and if you've been watching WPSU lately, you have been able to see your friends and neighbors in two 30-second spots that we were running. Those are on there as well. That is our gift to you for $75, or for $120, we'll send you two copies of the program. It's our way of saying thank you to you for your generous gift to WPSU to keep projects like Our Town happening right here in your public television station. Something else that we're doing tonight that's kind of cool is we are live tweeting. Hashtag OT Williamsburg. We already have some folks that have been tweeting in here tonight. There's one here from Kelly Over. Hey, Kelly. We're going to be seeing Kelly's mom, Kathy, who is right behind me here on phone one, telling a story here coming up in the next segment. So watch out for that. We also would love to be able to say thank you tonight to everybody that calls in, and we have our first person to say thank you to. Thanks to Dean and Ethel Moyer of Williamsburg. They are coming up in 1 month to their 70th wedding anniversary. So congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Moyer. And thank you also for supporting public television. 1-800-245-9779 is the number that you can call. All of the phones are still busy, but keep giving it a try. We have one line open. Oh, it just went. Give us a call, though. We'd love to be able to talk to you and hear your support for Williamsburg. Whitney?
Well, I've got some folks to thank, too, and this is very exciting. The Lilly family. Thanks to the Lilly family for being a part of Williamsburg Night here on WPSU. Also to Ethel, Dean, and Linda Moyer. Thank you so much for being a part of tonight's show. Also, to Overlane Farm, Kathy, Jay, and Kelly Over. Hey, Kelly Over. Hey. Tweeting and now being a part of tonight's show. And Kathy, coming up, she's going to give us a walking tour of Williamsburg. Thank you so much for being a part of tonight's show. You know, Kathy Over was one of the folks. There's Kathy right now on phone one, busy taking a phone call. Kathy Over and Lugene Shelley, the librarian, public librarian, and also Amy Jo White and Carly Rinaldi and a couple other folks, and also Julie Woodling, some of the folks who helped us get this whole project started in town and then helped us throw the community meeting together and bring so many folks together to start this project and share stories from Williamsburg, and we're seeing them come to life on screen tonight in the broadcast premiere of Our Town Williamsburg. This story is made possible by contributions from you tonight at 1-800-245-9779. And every single call, every single person that we thank, you're helping us celebrate stories from your hometown. And we know that Williamsburg is a town that really celebrates your local stories, your local heritage, with websites, with Facebook sites like Williamsburg Then and Now. You guys have so much to share, and you really take pride in it. And that's why we know this is a great show. And when we came to Williamsburg, we really felt so much pride from the folks in this town. 1-800-245-9779 to help share that spirit of Williamsburg. Give us a call and let us know this is something that you appreciate. Make that $75 contribution and we'll send you a copy of the show on DVD. But we want to hear from you right now. Right, Greg?
That's right. Call, make your pledge, $75, get you a DVD of the show. $120, we can send you two DVDs. Keep one, send one away. Just our way of saying thanks. When you become a member of WPSU and becoming member tonight, Ellen Blyler, of Martinsburg, in memory of her mother, Bertha Blylett, and Tom Byler. Thank you very much for that. And also we heard from Chuck and Jill Fitzgerald in Tyrone. Thank you very much. They want to say hi to everyone. And also Gracie Bingham Swindell of Martinsburg. Thank you very much for calling in and making a pledge. We have a lot of people we want to thank tonight. We want to get everybody's name in. It only happens if you call and make your pledge. If you don't know, this is our 73rd edition of the Our Town Project. We go to the town. We ask people to go out with their cameras and bring back stories about what's going on in their town, and they do. We don't tell them, you should do this, you should do that. They provide the content, and we just kind of curate it and make it all watchable. And it's a great way for us to do it. It's a public television type of thing. Only your public television station would do it. If you enjoy it, well, then your pledge right now is the one we're looking for. $75, $120. Maybe you can make a $500 pledge to support public television. No, not only do we do the Our Towns, but we provide a children's service 11 hours per day. We provide drama. We provide science. We provide information and news programming you can't get anywhere else. 1-800-245-9779, online at WPSU.org. And if you know somebody who lives out of town, call them up right now. Tell them to go online at WPSU.org/live, L-I-V-E, and they can watch the show and breaks and everything. And they can make a pledge. Right, Jessica?
That's right. We have more people that we would like to thank this evening, getting us started here with our first break here tonight with Our Town Williamsburg. The show is just getting started, and we are so glad that you're tuning in tonight to the Mingle family. Beth Mingle and family, thank you for your gift of support tonight. Thanks to the George Need family of Roaring Spring, a neighbor right there in the Cove. Thanks so much for your support. To the Cooper family, who are former residents of Williamsburg. They are from State College right now is where they're living. Thank you so much. And Gerald and Linda Smith. Linda's back there answering phones for us tonight. Thank you so much for your gift of support. Won't you be the next one to give us a call? 1-800-245-9779. Or, as you can tell, the phones are a little busy. So you can always go online to WPSU.org and make your pledge there. But the important thing is that you show your support for local programs like this. Remember, we are also live tweeting tonight, hashtag OTWilliamsburg. We've had a lot of people actually tweeting to us tonight already. We have people saying, great show so far, really enjoying learning about my hometown. And that's the really cool part about these shows, is that you learn something about your hometown, even if you've lived there your whole life. We're happy to be able to provide this service to you. But we can only do it with your support to keep it going. 1-800-245-9779 is the number where you can make your gift of support to our town, Williamsburg. And I believe, does Whitney have more names for us down there?
I do have some more folks to thank. You know, I couldn't hear Jessica over all the phones ringing, which is fantastic. But I wanted to point out that we've got some major Blue Pirate Pride going on in the back row over there. There's some Blue Pirate Pride. Linda Smith and some other folks, and Kathy Overs back there. They're busy taking some great phone calls from folks from Williamsburg, and we want to hear from you at 1-800-245-9779, like Larry and Susie Miller from Martinsburg. Thank you so much for being a part of tonight's show. Also, Todd Ross from Saxton. Thank you so much, Todd. And also Donna Showalter from Williamsburg. Thank you so much for being a part of tonight's show. We want to hear from you at 1-800-245-9779. Remember, make that contribution of $75, and we'd love to send you a copy of tonight's show on DVD. Your $120 contribution gets you two of those DVDs, and these have some great bonus features, including one on a great woman named Dorothy Kuntz, who we're going to learn a little bit more about later, but this is an extended feature. Also, we've got a one on William Kramer, who you're going to learn about later, too, and some of the trailers for the show. Those are some features we aren't able to show you tonight, but they are included on the DVD. 1-800-245-9779. Well, we were so welcomed into Williamsburg from the very beginning, Jessica and I and Bill Wallace, as we shot all of these great features and worked with the town. And it's really their footage and their stories that you're seeing come to life on screen, because this is their footage, their photos that are all part of these stories. And we want to hear from you in support of them at 1-800-245-9779. I think Greg has some more folks to thank, right,
well,
Greg?
Well, yes, all the phones are still busy, so if you have trouble getting through, just wait a minute and make another call, or go online to WPSU.org, make your pledge that way. Let's say thank you to Jeff Immler of Hollidaysburg for calling in a pledge. Tom and Dorothy Henderson of Hollidaysburg. Okay. Woo! Big fans, eh? Plows Masonry in Warrensburg. They're rock solid. Get it? No. And Mary and Willie Tressy or Treese? Trees. Thank you. Mary and Willie Trees. The Williamsburg called in, and they have fans, too. So thank you very much for calling in your pledge. We'll be back to more of Our Town Williamsburg in a minute. But now's your opportunity. Now's your chance to become a member of your public TV station. That's us, WPSU. We bring you programs year in, year out, day in and day out. And we ask you voluntarily, once in a while, help pay for them. $75, we can send you a copy of the show you're watching right now, Our Town Williamsburg. For $120, we can send you two DVDs. And the DVDs also have bonus features from Dorothy Kuntz, about Dorothy Kuntz and William Kramer. So they're extra footage on the DVDs that we couldn't squeeze into the show tonight. So that's just a little bonus for you. Call right now at 800-245-9779 and make your pledge. Go online at WPSU.org. You can also watch the show there as well. Oh, Jessica.
I have some more names to read, but we also have some late-breaking Twitter news. We have somebody joining us from Venezuela online who tweeted to us, which is pretty cool. So hello in South America. Hello, and thank you so much for joining us from Venezuela. And thank you from wherever you are joining us, whether it's from Williamsburg, from State College, or from another country. We are so proud to be able to bring you these stories, and it's a homecoming tonight, no matter where you are. It's a homecoming to support your town, Our Town Williamsburg, tonight right here on your public television station, WPSU. I do want to say, if you hear these crazy voices in the background of people shouting and hooting and hollering, we have a great little peanut gallery over here who's helping us out with names and cheering and encouraging us on. So we have our phone volunteers. We have our friends from Williamsburg who are joining us here in the studio to celebrate your town tonight. And whenever you do call in with your gift, we would love to be able to send you the DVD, but we also want to be able to thank you on air, because we truly appreciate each gift that comes in to be able to keep this program going. So let's read some names. Thanks to Don and Skip Pheasant of Martinsburg. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. Thanks to Joe, Beth, and Kara Lansbury of Williamsburg, I believe. Yes, thank you very much. Thanks to Jane Dibert of Williamsburg, and she says thanks to everyone who helped with the program. And I will echo that. We have some fantastic volunteers in Williamsburg, so thank you so much to everyone who helped out. And thanks to Ted and Carol Heil. Thanks to Ted Heil. And thank you so much for all that you did for this program. And we want to be able to thank you next at 1-800-245-9779. We're going to be going back to the program very shortly, but there's still time. Let's see. Are there any phones? There are no phones that are, but just keep on calling, because eventually you will get through, or you can go online to WPSU.org. Just be sure to show your support for your town and your public television station, Williamsburg. Whitney?
Thanks, Jessica. 1-800-245-9779. Thanks to Tyler and Valerie Pro, and also Richie, Taylor, Vince, and Nick Michelone. And also, I've got another couple here. Veronica Baroner and Annabelle Gunnett, and also Bruce and Paula Hamilton. Thank you to everybody calling in. We want to hear from you next. 1-800-245-9779. Stick around. There is so much more coming your way, including a visit to the library. Also, Tim Tate's going to take us to the biggest party that Williamsburg has ever seen, and he is hooting and hollering off set over there, because you know what? I'm going to throw out the challenge that there needs to be another party coming up in a few years for another celebration that we're going to talk about a little bit later in the evening. Just stay tuned for that. Also, Linda Smith is going to tell us all about the schools, and the mayor is going to talk to us about the fire department. So stay tuned. There is so much more coming, and we're just getting started, Williamsburg. 1-800-245-9779. If you'd like to get a copy of Our Town Williamsburg, we'd love to hear from you. Make a contribution of $75, and there are some great bonus features on this, but know that it's your contribution that makes this program possible and stories from your hometown possible as part of the Our Town series. Right, Greg?
That's right, and I'd say shout out to Colton Kessinger, who hopes Tim Tate makes an appearance. He will. Coming up. Coming up. Don't worry about it, okay? Thanks to Marlene Mungle of Williamsburg. Thank you very much, Marlene, for that pledge. Mark Deal, Ideal Hunt, whatever that, okay, in Williamsburg. Did I get that right? An anonymous pledge from Altoona for $75. Somebody giving the pledge. While a long-distance pledge from David Patterson, Jacksonville, Arkansas, called in, so Got fans in the crowd here. Also, Charlene Brantner and family of Williamsburg. Thank you very much. And one more here. Charlene Dixon, Shane Dixon, Charlene's, Shane's grandmother, Bill Lee, is her brother. So thank you very much for calling in. It's great. The people calling in, making those connections. 1-800-245-9779. The number for you to call. Let me turn my back on you for a second. All the phones are busy. 1-800-245-9779. Call with your pledge. You can go online. There's no waiting in line at WPSU.org, but I know you want to talk to your phones and your friends here. You know, all the people answering the phone are from Williamsburg. They came out tonight, came up through the storm and the thunder. Well, it wasn't too bad by the time they left. But they came up here tonight to volunteer their time and their efforts to take your pledges. So you call the number on your screen, toll-free call, 800-245-9779, and make a pledge and talk to the phone volunteers. WPSU.org is a way you can make a pledge too. Jessica?
Hashtag OT Williamsburg. Yes, Maddie, that is your dad yelling in the background. Having a very good time here in the studio, and we appreciate it very, very much. So we just wanted to say that. Okay. So we do have some more people that we would like to thank here this evening. Thanks to Dave and Teresa Caruder of McConnellstown. Thank you very much for your gift of support from McConnellstown. Thanks to the Travis Clausen family of Williamsburg. Thank you so much for your gift of support. Thanks to Kim Pearson Irvin, I believe it is. Thank you so much for your gift of support this evening. Thanks to the Evelyn Morelli family of Huntington, just down the road. Thank you so much for your gift of support. Thanks to Don and Mary Good Wagner of Tyrone. This is in memory of our parents and brother, George Good. So thank you so much for that gift this evening. And let's see here. Thanks to Sandra Kaufman of Williamsburg. Made her gift of support online at WPSU.org, which you can do as well if the phones are busy. Thanks to the Manning and Snare family of Williamsburg for their gift of support. To Nancy Smith of Springfield, Virginia, on behalf of Erdene Snare. Thank you so much for your gift of support this evening. We have so many more people to thank here tonight. 1-800-245-9779 is the number that you can call to make your gift of support. We have a couple more names here. Victoria Fry of Altoona, thank you for your gift of support. Thank you so much to all of these great folks. Keep on calling us. We are so glad to be able to hear from you tonight. 1-800-245-9779. Whitney?
Thanks, Jessica. I've got a special special message here. This one is from Dwayne White in Clearfield, and he would like to say hi to all of his friends and family in Williamsburg. And I just want to also throw out a great message that we have been seeing some of our fantastic friends from Williamsburg here in the studio. And I just want to say, don't they look fabulous tonight? They look fantastic. And we are so excited that they have come to the studios tonight to be with us, and they are doing a great job. And you guys in Williamsburg and all over are doing a great job supporting all their stories tonight and seeing all their hard work come to life on screen on WPSU, and we can't thank you enough. So Dwayne, thank you so much for calling in and saying hi to all your friends in Williamsburg. So hi Dwayne, and hi to all of his friends in Williamsburg too. Also, we want to thank Scott and Melissa Whitaker. Thank you so much for calling in. And also, Tim Brantner, thank you so much. And he says he's very blessed to grow up in this town, and he misses the wonderful people. And he's in State College, so Tim misses all of his Williamsburg friends. So thank you so much, Tim. And also Fred Biddle and family from Williamsburg. Thank you so much, Fred, for calling in. Also, Melissa Hartman, thank you. Called in for the community. Thank you so much. We thank you for your kind words. Also, 1-800-245-9779. Be a part of Williamsburg Night here on WPSU. A contribution of $75 will get you a copy of tonight's program and all these great stories on DVD with some great bonus feature. Give us a call and be a part of tonight's celebration. Right, Greg?
That's right. Coming up, don't go away, we have Kathy Over talking about doing a walking tour of the town. Lou Jean Shelley does a library, and Lou Jean has the best handwriting, I swear. I'm getting forms, and they're beautiful. Tim Tate, you're going to talk about the Bicentennial Celebration. David Rice at the Clover Creek Cheese Cellar. Linda Smith is going to talk about the schools, and Mayor Ted Heil will talk about the fire department. There's a hot time. So we have some thanks. John, Chris, and Lois Miller from Hollidaysburg, thank you very much. Jennifer and Troy Metzler of Martinsburg, thank you very much. John and Connie Bolger of Williamsburg, thank you very much. Larry Berger of Williamsburg called in. Chris Greaser of Woodstock, Georgia. Woodstock, Georgia called in. Georgia's on my mind. And one, this is a real long distance one too. Richard Pope from St. Helens, Oregon called in. So thank you very much, Richard, for tuning us in on WPSU.org/live and watching us and making your pledge. 1-800-245-9779. We're going back to the show in just a minute. Don't forget, $75. We'll send you a copy of the show, Our Town Williamsburg, with extra bonus features about Dorothy Kunz and William Kramer. And for $120, two DVDs. That's our way of saying thanks for your support of your public TV station, WPSU. Our phone volunteers tonight are from Williamsburg. We thank them for coming up. We'd like to thank Otto's Pub and Brewery here in State College for helping us with the food donation to keep our volunteers fed. But we want to thank you for your pledge when you call the number on the screen, 800-245-9779, or you go online at WPSU.org. and make your pledge. Jessica, more people to thank?
More people to thank. It's my favorite thing to do for these Our Town shows is to thank people on air. We want to be able to personally thank you for your gift of support because you're showing us how much you care about local programming right here in Central Pennsylvania. So we have an anonymous gift from Huntington. You know who you are. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. Thanks to Paul and Shirley Kurtzflaw of Williamsburg. Thank you very much for your gift this evening.
Thank you.
Thanks to Troy Shock and Shock Electric, thank you so much for your gift of support this evening. Thanks to the Andersons of Spring Street in Williamsburg, thank you very much for your gift of support. Thanks to Bill and Susan Baker family of Williamsburg, thank you very much this evening. And we have a special thanks to Pastor Dennis Pruitt of Williamsburg. Thank you very much. You're going to see Pastor Pruitt's story a little bit later on in the show, so stay tuned for that. We are going to be going back to the show very, very soon, but you still have time to call 1-800-245-9779. Actually, it would be a good idea to write that number down, and we go back to the show. The phones might slow down a little bit, and you'll have your opportunity to call then, and we'll thank you in the next break. But whatever you do, whatever choice you make, please go to the phone, make that pledge, go on the web, make that pledge, show your support for local programs just like this right here in Central PA. Whitney?
That's a great idea to write that number down. Also, remember to keep those tweets coming during the show because we will definitely want to read those after this next break because we've got some great stories coming up. Now, we've been talking about what's coming up in the next segment, but you know what? There are a lot more great stories coming up, including a visit to Royer Mansion. We're going to learn about William S. Rhodes from Chris Brown. Also, the Women's Civic Club. And we're going to learn about the alumni band and U.S. Envelope. Also, some local iron furnaces and so much more. So stick around. There is a lot more coming your way. Right now, give us a call, 1-800-245-9779. Lou G needs a call right there. And I'd like to do a very special message right now. This is from, we got a call from Vaughn Kanagi from Williamsburg, a pledge in memory of Reverend Wilbert and June Banks. Thank you so much. The very nice messages that we get are great to read on air, whether it's someone that you want to do in memory or wishing someone a happy anniversary, or if you want to wish, you know, something out to the class of a certain year. Give us a call and let us know who you want to send a message out to. We love to read it on air. Also, thanks to Gladys Criswell from Martinsburg. Thank you, Gladys. And Sharon Gleam from Williamsburg. Thank you as well. We want to hear from you next. Also, we heard from Jerry and Pam Hoy. Thank you so much. 1-800-245-9779. Wow, Jerry and Pam are getting a lot of love. Who's Greg got to thank?
I have somebody in Du Bois, Gail and Frank. I want to say Mazicek or Mazicek. A lot of vowels. Sorry. Thank you very much, Gail and Frank. I know I slotted your name, but we certainly appreciate you calling in. Well, actually, you didn't. You did it on the web at WPSU.org. Ed Allender from Indiana, in memory of his mom and dad, Sadie and Luther Allender. We thank you very much. Also, we heard from Charles and Renee Bingham, along with Jaden and Krista. They're from Williamsburg. And we heard all the way from Elida, Ohio, Ronnie and Bobby Silbaugh, Jr. Thank you very much for calling in that pledge. It's 1-800-245-9779. All the phones, I see one phone down. Oh, it's not busy. 1-800-245-9779. We have nine phones. They get busy really quick. But if you have trouble getting through, just, you know, wait a minute or two. You can always call while the show's on. I know you don't want to do that, but that's when the phones aren't very busy. We can call in, too. 1-800-245-9779. $75, we can send you a DVD of the show you're watching. Or for $120, we can send you two DVDs. The DVDs have bonus features featuring Dorothy Kuntz and William Kramer. And just our way of saying thanks for your support of your public TV station, WPSU. Now, as the camera pans there, you see all these people. Not only do they have pirate pride, but they're also the people who helped put this show together. We couldn't do it without their support, and we can't make public television happen without your support. Your dollars go to purchase, produce, and broadcast the programs that you watch here on WPSU. That's why your dollar is important. So call right now with your pledge. If you've already made a pledge, thank you. If you haven't, what are you waiting for? Jess?
That's right. Whenever you do call in with your gift of support, remember, for $75, we'll send you a copy of tonight's program, Our Town Williamsburg, or for $120, we'll send you two copies of the program. And we would also love to be able to thank you on air this evening. So we have some more names to thank before we get back to the show. Thanks to Roscoe and Dorothy Caruder of Williamsburg. Thank you so much for your gift of support. Thanks to the Williamsburg Beverage Company. Thank you so much for your gift of support this evening. To Fran and Susan Camerato of Williamsburg, thank you so much for your gift this evening. And we want to say thanks to Tina and Bud Mingle of Williamsburg, to Larry Eid, thank you so much for your gift, and to Carly Rinaldi. You're going to see Carly a little later on in the program as well. Thank you so much for your gift of support. If you didn't get through on the phones, write that number down, 1-800-245-9779. Give us a call during the show. You can always go online also to WPSU.org to make your gift of support. But the important thing is that you show your gift of support this evening, show your support this evening, and to show that you care about programs just like this one that you're not going to find anywhere else. We were so lucky to be able to go into the community of Williamsburg and to have these great people welcome us in and make us part of this community. And it's what we are proud to be able to bring to you tonight, but we can only do it with your support. So go to the phone, 1-800-245-9779. You can also go online to WPSU.org. But for now, we're going back to Our Town, Williamsburg.
You can also make your pledge at WPSU.org. Click on Contribute at the top of the page. It's always available and easy to use. Thanks.
My name's Kathy Over, and I'm going to do a walking tour of Williamsburg. I'm a teacher at Williamsburg Elementary School. I teach sixth grade, and part of our Pennsylvania history course that we do there is I've kind of constructed a history of Williamsburg. The students and I go on the walking tour after we finish the unit. The kids really, really like it. It's probably one of their favorite things we do in sixth grade. One of the places that we always go to is the cemetery. It's the Methodist Cemetery, and it's right down actually from the school buildings. And this is the place where Jacob Ake and his wife Catherine are buried. There's a monument to Jacob Ake. I kind of start here with the kids so that they know a little bit about it. Jacob Ake actually came from Maryland to this area. The Big Spring is kind of one of the places that Williamsburg's known for. When people say, oh, Williamsburg, and you can say, well, you can visit the Big Spring. People who've lived here and then moved away, one of the things when they come back, they always go to the Big Spring. The water from the Big Spring actually flows all the way through Williamsburg, and it comes down the race. And this is where the Grisma was. They actually used a water wheel to power it, where you see the present-day Borough Building. Actually, before that, there was a big building there that actually housed an opera house in Williamsburg. It housed the public library at one time. There was a department store there. It's pretty interesting, though, that little old Williamsburg had an opera house. You didn't have to go very far to go to the opera at one time. High Street is probably the main street of Williamsburg. One of the things that's on High Street is what we call the Williamsburg Hotel. And that was built actually by a man by the name of Charles Schwab, who was involved in the steel industry. And he had been born in Williamsburg and lived here till he was about 5 years old. But he always loved Williamsburg. Around 1900, some of the business leaders of Williamsburg got together and decided that they needed to look at a new industry. And as we said, the Big Spring, which produces the 6 million gallons of water, and the fact that we're surrounded by timber and lumber, decided that maybe a paper mill would be a good enterprise. But of course, it was going to take a lot of money to do that. So they went to Charles Schwab, and they asked him about investing, and he was more than happy. So in 1903, they just started building the paper mill. And the yellow building that you see, the Williamsburg Hotel, was a building that he also built because he knew there'd be a lot of people who wanted to come in and see what this paper mill was all about. A lot of things, a lot of history that people don't really know about until you kind of dive into what Williamsburg's all about. In fact, I have parents stopping me and saying, you know, every time we go somewhere, Mom, did you know this? Dad, did you know this? It's neat to see the kids because my students are the children of kids that I've had in school. And so it's neat because it is a family community.
My name is Lee Jean Shelley, and I'm here to talk about the Williamsburg Public Library. The library began in 1950 with the Women's Civic Club. Some of the women thought that the community needed a library, so they looked for some spaces, and they found a vacant space in the back of the old borough building down on the 300 block of East 2nd Street. And the problem was it wasn't ready to be a library, so some of their husbands helped fix it up, and they also used the wood shop at the high school to build the shelves and the tables and things that were in the library. And then the members of the Civic Club also staffed the library. Sometime in the late 1960s, 1968 or 69, the board decided that they had outgrown the space at the borough building, so they moved to the old Farmers and Merchants Bank building in the 400 block of West 2nd Street. Then in the late 1990s, the Presbyterian Church did not have enough congregation to support the building. So rather than tear the building down or close it, they offered it to the library board for a dollar. Of course, the board jumped on that. It cost a lot more than a dollar to redo it. We probably had about $250,000 in renovation. But we used a Keystone grant and a couple other grants and community support to build the library. It was an awful lot like the first library. The firemen helped to paint. We had people from the community help move everything in. This new location is all on one floor. It's handicapped accessible. There's a parking lot. It's just a much better space for us to use as a library and to do programming. We do a lot of programs. We still focus on children's programs, and the Women's Civic Club is still active in supporting the library. They provide volunteers and financial assistance to do a story hour that runs for about 12 to 15 weeks each spring and fall. We do an art camp in the summer. We do that with the assistance of the Blair County Library System. And we work with the summer recreation program that the borough has every summer. Libraries are really moving towards a more technological age, so we have a computer lab. We offer free Wi-Fi if someone wants to bring their own devices in. We offer classes on Pinterest, and we've done classes on eBay. We also offer eBooks. We really tried to jump into social media with the Facebook page. It reaches a whole different group of people, mostly younger people, who stay in touch with the library that way. It also allows us to stay in touch with people from far away. I grew up in Williamsburg, too. My family has always been very active in things that go on in Williamsburg. Both my father and my grandfather were on city council. My family actually settled out in Shelleytown in the late 1790s, so I really do feel roots here. We try to listen to what the community wants and provide what they want in terms of programming and materials and things like that. And I think because we're such a small library and because our employees have grown up here in Williamsburg and they're Williamsburg natives, they know the people who come in here and they know their needs and they're very responsive to what the patrons want. That's our goal.
My name is Tim Tate. And I am here to talk about the bicentennial celebration that the town had in 1990. Records showed that Jacob Ake settled here in 1790, paddled up, clear up the Juniata. And at that time, it was known as Ipswich. That was the Indian name for it, which meant the land of the Great Spring. So for 3 or 4 years, a lot of people, probably at least 30 people in the beginning and more after that, started to put together this 9-day celebration for July of 1990.
Happy birthday, Williamsburg!
Just about anybody could be involved. We had people from civic organizations, we had people from businesses and industry, and we just had anybody that was willing to participate in it. The celebration was planned for 9 days, July 28th through August 5th, 1990. And it covered 2 weekends and a week in between. And each day had a theme, so to speak, to it. Out of the 9 days, I think either 4 or 5 of the days, there were major parades, like agricultural parade, veterans parade, firemen's. And they were big parades, most of them a couple hours long. That's the most I've ever seen the community brought together. The homes, almost every home was decorated in some manner with bunting and flags and all kind of patriotic type things, and the town really looked nice. It was really on top of its game.
Happy birthday, dear Williamsburg. Happy birthday to you.
One of the biggest parties the town ever knew. It was almost just like a one big class family type reunion. People that you hadn't seen for years were here, and you know, it was great to see all these different people and to remember everybody had a part. Right now I understand that they're forming, yes, for would be 2015 would be the 225th celebration. The town will come together. It's just a nice, close-knit community, and I enjoy small-town life here.
I'm David Rice. I'm here to talk about our experience of producing cheese here in Williamsburg, Pennsylvania. We moved to Williamsburg about 20 years ago because we knew it was a very good agriculture area. We were looking for a farming area where there were other farmers and where the soil was good and where we could start a dairy farm. We found this area and fell in love with it. We really enjoyed the agricultural history and just the way this whole community supported agriculture. We started out as a traditional dairy farm, and after trying that for about 2 years, we decided to make some changes, and we turned into a seasonal grass-based dairy, which means that we have our cows out on pasture as much of the year as possible, eating fresh green grass. We knew that there are some benefits of our cows being out on pasture, both for the cow's health and for the health of the people that drink that milk or use the products made from that milk. And we were looking for a way to get a better price for our milk because of that, and realized that cheese would be the best thing for us to do in this area. We start our cheese-making process by getting the cows in from the pasture at about 6 o'clock in the morning. We milk the cows, and the milk goes directly from the milking parlor into the cheese vat. One of our children comes out about 7 o'clock and starts the cheese-making process by adding cultures to the cheese. Then that culture actually starts changing the lactose in the cheese into lactic acid, and that's the first step in the cheese-making process. The next process is to add rennet, which is a thickening agent that causes the milk to get thick, kind of more like yogurt or a jello pudding type thing. And then we take a cheese harp or a curd knife and cut that thickened milk into cheese curds and whey. The whey continues to come out of the cheese curds over the next 2 or 3 hours. And by that time, we pretty much have the curds that have become the cheese, and the whey is drained off. The curds are then put into a cheesecloth inside of a cheese hoop, and it sits for up to 24 hours. And during that 24 hours, about every 4 hours, we turn that wheel inside of the cheese hoop so that the whey can continue to drain off. The final step to cheese making is adding the salt. We weigh out the right amount of salt for the cheese, and over a 24-hour period, continue to just sprinkle that salt on and let it be absorbed into the curds. We've been selling our cheese at a number of local farmers markets as far away as Philadelphia and Pittsburgh, and in the area more at State College and also out at Ligonier, and we're also working in the Altoona area to work at some of the farmers markets there. We really enjoy this Pirate Blue, and we chose that name because Williamsburg is home of the Blue Pirates, so we named our blue cheese Pirate Blue, especially for them.
We've enjoyed it as a family. Our original idea was to do something that the kids become involved in once they got a little bit older, and it looks like that may be happening, so we will see what happens in the future. We just really enjoy the way Williamsburg supports agriculture. The community farm show and the other farmers in the community really made us feel welcome here and made it to be a great place to raise our children.
My name is Linda Smith, and I'm the superintendent at the Williamsburg Community School District, and I am also a 1975 graduate, which I am very proud of. I would like to just discuss with you today the wonderful school district that we have. The school district is along the Frankstown branch of the Juniata River. There are two townships, Catherine Township and Woodbury Township, and the borough itself, which consists of 64 square miles for the school district. The elementary building was built in 1942, and the high school was built in 1918. Through the years, there's been several renovations, but you know, you have to compliment the custodial staff and the maintenance department for what they do, and the board to support that, to keep our buildings looking the way they do. We have 502 students in kindergarten through 12th grade. Our faculty are 51 strong, and many of them are graduates of Williamsburg. I don't think that you would probably find another school district with so many graduates. It's always amazing to see how the community comes and steps up to anything that we might need for families, for children. It's just amazing, the community pride we have. We're trying to relate Williamsburg themes to the school, the community theme to the school, so that the children become more involved and see how important their community is. We have a new bridge in Williamsburg, so we took the seniors from 2012 to the bridge and had their picture taken. I started with the elementary kids many years ago to always share the Blue Pirate spirit. And I taught them that the Blue Pirate spirit was respect and kindness. And if you show those two things to other individuals, you'll go far in life. We had an art teacher, Mr. William Kramer, and he was very strong in the Historical Society of Williamsburg. One day he said, Linda, he said, do you know how we got that Blue Pirate, you know, insignia? And I said, no. And he said, well, the pirates were coming down on the ships into the canal in Point View. And he said, they had ink, and they poured that ink in the water, and we became the Blue Pirates. I tell everyone that. I think I have blue in my blood. It's just a school spirit that is just phenomenal. I mean, you can't get enough of it. If you're really into your tradition and your pride and you want to promote that, you're a Blue Pirate.
Hi, I'm Ted Howe, Chief of the Williamsburg Fire Department. We actually cover Williamsburg Borough. We cover Catherine Township, Woodbury Township, and part of Houston Township. Right now we're running about 35 people, or anywhere from 35 to 40. We have two engines. We have a tanker, a brush truck, two ambulances. We have 8 to 10 firefighter 1 certifieds. We have four firefighter 2, and here in the near future, we're going to have probably four more that are going to be firefighter 1. I also have four paramedics. Some are firefighter 1 certified too, but I have a couple paramedics that volunteer their time too. We went into a project with the Hollidaysburg Ambulance several years ago. They provide us with a daylight crew. The daylight crew works from 8 in the morning to 4 in the afternoon. And then after that, it's all volunteer. So we have folks that are on call in the evenings. The people that were running the community center, the board come to the fire company and asked us if we would like to take it over. And after some long and hard thought, we're going to take it over. And we're going to still run it as the Williamsburg Veterans Memorial Center. We're going to try to update it. We are supported mostly by taxes. We do some fundraisers, and that's pretty much how the operation is run. We're out and about. We have training on Tuesday nights. Every Tuesday night, there's somebody at the fire hall. You know, so if anybody needs anything or wants to talk to anybody or just hang out, you know, they come down and hang out. There's a gazebo down there. On any given day during the summertime, there's somebody sitting in there just watching the traffic go by. It's kind of a cool place to sit around at. I love the people. They're a good bunch of people in this town. You can tell when you get emotional about it. It's a fun place to live, it really is.
Stick around for more stories from your friends and neighbors as we tour Royer Mansion, meet up with the fabulous Miss Dorothy Koontz, and hear about an organization making Williamsburg a better place. Now, show your support for Williamsburg and WPSU by making a pledge. Thanks.
Thanks so much for joining us tonight for Our Town Williamsburg. Hope you enjoyed that portion of the show. Before I can even say it, the phones are ringing. 1-800-245-9779 is the number that you can call to support this great program, Our Town Williamsburg, right here on your public television station, WPSU. Whenever you do call in with your gift of support tonight, we would love to be able, at $75, to send you a copy of tonight's program. That is our gift, our way of saying thank you to you for your support of Our Town Williamsburg and of WPSU. Or at $120, if that is a level that you can afford. We'd love to be able to send you two DVDs this evening, one to keep and maybe one to give to a friend or a family member. And, you know, I hate to be the one to say it, but, you know, the holidays, they are approaching quickly. So might be something to put on your wish list this year to give to a friend. And I want to encourage you this evening to get this very quickly. If you can use the credit card, that is what's processed the fastest if it's something that you need to have right away. So 1-800-245-9779. Something else that we're also doing tonight with every call, we would love to be able to thank you tonight on air for your support. So let's get started. We have a bunch of names. Thanks to Gerda Strohmeyer and friends at the Senior Center in Williamsburg. Thank you so much for your gift this evening and for tuning in and joining us. Thanks to the Martis family of Williamsburg. Thank you so much for your gift of support. Thanks to Deb Stauffer of Center Hall. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. Thanks to Sam and Emily Granis of Hollidaysburg, just up the road from Williamsburg. Thank you so much for your gift. Thanks to Trisha, Jason, Tyler, and Miranda Bell Radman of Williamsburg. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. Thanks to Harry and the kids, Harry Mullins and the kids of Williamsburg. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. This is thanks to Sharon Malone of Williamsburg, Bill and Sharon Malone, and Nancy and Fred Hurdle from Hollidaysburg. This is in memory of Norma Schoenholtz, I believe it is. Shanholtz, excuse me. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. And let's see, thanks to Jordan and Ian Rote and Shannon I of Tyrone. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. And thank you to Brandon and Danielle Rents of Huntingdon, thank you so much for your gift of support this evening. We want to be able to thank you next at 1-800-245-9779. I believe that Kevin has some more names for us over here, right?
I sure do, Jessica. My name's Kevin Conaway. I'm a producer here at WPSU, your local public television station. And I just want to talk a little bit tonight about this production. For those of you who don't know, when In Our Town happens, Jessica and Whitney, they head into a town. They take a videographer, Bill Wallace, and an audio person, Chris Youngkin, along, and they go in and they meet with the townspeople, and they talk about some story ideas. And what is really amazing is, while they're kind of facilitating the event, the people of the town, the people of Williamsburg, become the producers of this program. They choose the stories, and they choose these really inspirational and the wonderful nuggets about their town, and then they're showcased tonight on this program that you're watching. And it's really an amazing experience for everyone involved, and I've had a chance to tag along a few times, and I really enjoy it. So if that's the kind of thing that you appreciate, if you enjoy watching programs like this, if you enjoy being proud of your hometown, one of the wonderful Central Pennsylvania communities that WPSU supports, I'm asking you to put a dollar value on that, to give us a call at 1-800-245-9779 and say, I want to support more programming like this. I want to preserve the stories of my community. And it's very simple to do that. The phones have been ringing throughout the break, and you're keeping us really busy tonight, and we appreciate that. And I do want to send some thank yous along. We want to thank Alan Saylor of Pennsylvania Furnace for calling in. Alan, thank you. We want to thank Ellie Detweiler of Williamsburg for calling in. Ellie, thank you. And I've noticed she's a
she's a First Street address. I've heard some Second and Third Street competition here, so there seems to be a little bit of a competition coming on. We want to thank Tim Metzler, also of Williamsburg. We want to thank Vince Appleman of Lower Burrell, Pennsylvania. And that's Pepper and Sandy Appleman. We want to thank, and I should have mentioned for the Tim Metzler, it's Tim and Kathy Metzler and family of Williamsburg. We want to thank Deka Abernathy of Deka's Downtown Saloon, Salon in Williamsburg, Pennsylvania. We want to thank Steve and Lois Lynn of State College for calling in. We want to thank everybody's laughing at my little saloon comment there. We're having a good time here in the studio tonight. Dan Zimmerman of Somerset, Pennsylvania. Dan and Debbie Zimmerman, class of 67 at Williamsburg, I'm assuming. Some Blue Pirate pride right there. And we want to thank Gary and Charlotte Irvin of Williamsburg for calling in. And we have many more thank yous. We're going to continue. One of our pleasures here as host of this program is to take a moment to thank each of you individually for your gift of support to your local public television station, WPSU. And I'm going to send it on over to Whitney, who I know has a huge stack of thank yous.
I do have a huge stack. Know that it's each one of these folks and you when you give us a call at 1-800-245-9779 that makes programs like the Our Town series and Our Town Williamsburg that's premiering tonight right now possible with a contribution of support. Your call makes it possible. Like Tim, Trish, and Timmy Ropchak from Williamsburg, you're helping make tonight's show possible and celebrating Williamsburg stories. Also, the Breitenbach family from Altoona, thank you so much. And Dee and Dan Verbonitz, thank you so much for being a part of tonight's show. Also, Tim and Rhonda Cooper from Hollidaysburg called in honor of Gene and Bob Cooper and Chuck and Anita Kelly. Thank you so much for calling in with that great message. Also, we heard from William, Nancy, Beth, and Bria and Chrissy Singer from Williamsburg. Thank you so much. And also Rod and Trudy Hinnish. Thank you so much. Also, we heard from Lucy Miller and family. Thank you for calling in. Also, here's one from Jim and Melinda Flagg and family. Thank you for calling in. Also, Dr. Patrick Rice and Cindy Rice. And here's one from Mr. and Mrs. Stanley and Patty Kinzinger and their kids, Courtney, Cassandra, Cody, Caitlin, and Shirley Breitenbach, another Breitenbach family. Thank you for calling in. And they're over in Williamsburg. And here's Jim and Michelle. Cassandra, thank you so much for logging on to WPSU.org and making your contribution. And also, Tom Tate, thank you so much for being a part of tonight's show. And Dottie Hurd from 10 Mile, Tennessee. Oh, thank you so much. And Patty Miller from Williamsburg. Thank you, Patty. And also, we heard from Danielle Wambacher. Thank you so much, Danielle. And here's Dan and Phyllis Stoltz in memory of their parents. Thank you so much. And Tracy Lilly. Thank you, Tracy. And we've got one here in honor of Joe Saylor from the Saylor family. We'd love to hear from you next at 1-800-245-9779. Now, we've got a very special challenge here. Here we go. Now, we've got this great challenge that's connected to Tim Tate's story. So we heard Tim Tate do the bicentennial story, and we heard him say that in 2015, it's going to be the 225th anniversary of Williamsburg. Well, I think we can get 225 calls. What do you think? I think we're well on our way, and you can do it, Williamsburg. I know you can at 1-800-245-9779. Let's do it. Let's support stories from your hometown told by your friends and neighbors. Let's celebrate all your stories. Williamsburg, we know you have so much Blue Pirate pride and want to share it right now. Give us a call and make it possible. Remember, that $75 contribution gets you a copy of the program on DVD. But the most important thing is to step up and show that spirit for your hometown. Right, Jessica?
That's right. And you know what? We are well on our way to that goal. I just heard that we are up to 150 calls so far tonight. That is unbelievable. So thanks so much, but let's keep it going. everyone tonight, Williamsburg, 1-800-245-9779. I have more people that we'd like to thank here tonight. Thanks to special shout out to Bill Lee for the American Legion tonight in Williamsburg. Thanks so much for all that you've done to help this show happen, and thanks for your support tonight. Thanks to Roy and Sherry Edmondson of Williamsburg. Thank you so much for your gift of support. Thanks to Patricia Bonebreak of Williamsburg. She is giving, there we go. This is in memory of her parents, Tom and Catherine Bonebreak, who were teachers in Williamsburg. And you know what? That's one thing that we have really noticed about this town. This town really values their school system. And we have so many representatives here. And what do we keep hearing about? Blue Pirate Pride is a big part of this community. So thanks to those folks. This is a pledge in memory of Lynn Wimp Rinaldi. Thank you so much for your gift of support this evening. We have an anonymous gift for Altoona. You know who you are. Thank you for stepping up and making your gift of support to public television. Thanks to Wayne Grove. This is in memory of Paul Grove. Thank you so much for your gift of support tonight. Thanks to John Gorsuch of Williamsburg. This is for actually John, Donna, Ben, and Sarah in memory of Adams. Thank you so much for your gift of support this evening. Thanks to Justin and Megan Becker of Williamsburg. Thanks so much for your gift. Thanks to Georgia Lauer Trail. See, I caught myself. Georgia Lauer of East Freedom in memory of Jack Lauer. Thank you so much for your gift of support. Thanks to Ivan and Bonnie Albright of Williamsburg. Thank you so much to Eric and Leroy Bumgardner of Williamsburg. And just a couple more here. Thanks to Arlene Ake family. Ake, relation to Ake Town, the original name of Williamsburg, possibly. Thanks to Margie Showalter in memory of Lee. And to Paula Keithley and family of Williamsburg. Those are just a handful of the people that have called in here tonight. We want to be able to thank you next at 1-800-245-9779. Remember, with your gift of support at $75, we would love to be able to send you a copy to thank you for your gift of support to WPSU. We at $120, we could send you two copies of the program, but whatever level works for you is showing your support for public television. Now, the phones are all busy, but we're going to be here for a little bit more, so keep on trying. 1-800-245-9779. Kevin?
That's right. I think we have one phone open right now, so if you give us a call, 1-800-245-9779, we'll be glad to take that call. You can also log on to wpsu.org/live. It is a safe, wpsu.org. It is a safe, secure site, and we'll be glad to take your pledge there as well if you're having a little trouble getting through to the phones. If you want to write down that number, 1-800-245-9779. The phones were busy throughout the as we go back to the program, but it will give you an opportunity. Things slow down a little bit then and give you an opportunity to give us a call then. But you are keeping us quite busy tonight, Williamsburg, and we are quite proud of that. There is really blue pirate pride and spirit here in this room. And, you know, it really was inspirational to me when Linda Saylor was talking about how, you know, she teaches the young students to be kind and be respectful, and it takes you far in life. And I think what a great lesson for children, and you can really see that the people of Williamsburg take that to heart, and I'm just enjoying watching the program and spending the evening with these folks here in Williamsburg tonight. We have many thank yous to pass along, and we want to thank Father Aaron Magsudi, who is actually coming up in one of the future segments talking about the Catholic Church in town. Father Aaron, thank you for your pledge. We want to thank Barry and Diane England for calling in, and I believe they're Williamsburg. We want to thank Brian Showalter of Williamsburg for calling in. We want to thank Shelby Maynard of State College calling in memory of Darrell Stoltz, thank you for calling in. We want to thank Don and Donna Irvin, I believe also of Williamsburg, for calling in tonight. We want to thank Dave Bigelow of Williamsburg, Dave is part of the Canoe Valley Farm, with Dave and Patty Bigelow calling in to support their local public television station, WPSU. We want to thank Jeff, Tracy, Anna, and Grace Colbert for calling in, or Colbert. I'm not quite sure how you pronounce that. I've seen that both ways. Colbert, I'm told from our great peanut gallery here in the studio tonight from Williamsburg. We want to thank Adam, Amy, Jack, Drew, and Ayla of the Clover Lark Farm for calling in. Oh, I think they're on the lane there in Williamsburg, PA. Yep. We want to thank Dawn, Lori, Wade, Lauren, Parkle Road for calling in, also of Williamsburg. We want to thank Thomas Tate for calling in, also of Williamsburg. A lot of, I think tonight we're going to read every name in Williamsburg, I believe, on the air tonight. Yes. We want to thank Charlie and Brenda Funk of Lewistown, Pennsylvania, for calling in. Lewistown, that's my hometown, so thanks for calling in, Charlie and Brenda Funk. We want to thank Jamie Smith of Williamsburg, calling Jamie, Aspen, Saxton, and John Smith for calling in. Smith, that's an easy last name. I think I can handle that one. We also want to thank Virginia Kelly of the Williamsburg Ladies Fire Auxiliary calling in in support of the Williamsburg Ladies Fire Auxiliary. And we thank you, and you're getting a big shout out here in the studio tonight. We still have a lot of thank yous, and so we really appreciate it, folks. We want to thank Lester Houck, Lester and Linda Houck, also of Williamsburg. Thank you for calling in tonight. And we want to thank Randy and Cindy Fry of Williamsburg calling in. And they did a shout out to Kiara. Thank you, Randy and Cindy Fry, who's shouting out to Kiara. Bonnie Hammond, Billy and Bonnie Hamden, thank you calling in, also from Williamsburg. And we have some special in memorials tonight, and we want to thank you for that. We have a little craziness going on here in the background. So we want to thank Edmund Majewski, who called in memory of his mother, Janice Majewski, pronounced. So we thank you, Edmund, for calling in. It's really, I think, these types of programs that help you remember your parents and your loved ones and those who have gone before you. And just, it brings you a connection to community. And you know, Linda Lang is also calling in memory of Ronald and Joyce Michelone, I believe, McAlone. We want to thank also Richard Forshee, Dick, who called in memory of his deceased wife, Sandy Edwards Forshee, and his deceased daughter, Karen Fry. We also want to thank Eileen Nicholas of Williamsburg. Bruce and Eileen Nichols, they're calling in memory of their son, Scott Nichols. And we want to thank Fran Forsyth of Tyrone, Pennsylvania. She's calling in from Fran and Evelyn in memory of Bill and Nancy Forsyth. So some really special memories tonight. I know these types of programs bring great memories of your community that you grew up in and really allow you to connect with that community. And that's what we're asking you to think about. These are stories of your loved ones, of your community, and it's a way to preserve them. And there's nobody else out there doing it. Public television is the only place that puts your community first and the good stories of your community. And if you value that, we're asking you to call in tonight. Yeah, hey, buddy. We're asking you to call that guy back there. He's giving us a lot of help tonight. I believe that's Gabe running around back there. I just got video bombed by Gabe. 1-800, now he disappeared now. 1-800-245-9779 is the number to call, or you can log on to WPSU.org. And I see Whitney has another large stack of thank yous. Thank you, Williamsburg. Whitney.
I do have a large stack, and I just want everyone to know that we are taking the time to thank each and every single person who calls in, because this is public television, and we want everyone in Williamsburg and beyond to know that it's every single one of these individuals who makes programs like this possible, who make all the programs on public television, on WPSU possible, especially the local stories, like the Our Town series possible. We could not do this series without support from viewers like you. And Kevin put it so well when he said, celebrate the great stories from your hometown. You know, we're celebrating all of the wonderful history and all of the great, great things that Williamsburg has to share with all of Central Pennsylvania and beyond, because this is streaming right now on WPSU.org, and we're so proud to be able to bring it to you. But it's individuals like the names that we're reading tonight that are able to make this all possible. So thank you to each and every single person calling in tonight. And we said we've got that goal of 225 because we want to celebrate with Williamsburg when 2015 hits, and we're celebrating the 225th anniversary. So we hope we can get there, but it's about celebrating the community of Williamsburg together. And that's what you're doing right now when you're calling in and saying, hey, these stories are important to me. When I see them on my local PBS station, I know that I'm a part of that because I'm calling in and making it known that I want to see more stories like this from my hometown. Like Sean Hanna, who called in and said, this is a wonderful program and I can't wait to see a wonderful colleague, George Dempsey. He is an amazing elementary teacher in State College and an even better person. I saw him answering phones and was so excited. I can't wait to hear his tour of Royer Mansion. So thank you so much for sharing that with us. And thank you for making your contribution online at WPSU.org. Also,
Here's another one. Just wanted to thank the Williamsburg Ambulance for helping my mother tonight. Oh my goodness, thank you so much. And we hope everything's okay. And that's Herm and Karen Arnold from Williamsburg. Well, Herm and Karen, we hope that your mother is okay. And we thank you so much for being a part of tonight's celebration and for sharing that with us. And we wish you all the best. Also, James Gahan, thank you. I hope that's right. Thank you so much for calling in and being a part of tonight's show. Also, here's one from Charlie the Barber and LaRue in Williamsburg. That's LaRue Hauser. Thank you so much for calling in and being a part of tonight's program. Here's one from Tim, Trisha, and Bella Strohmeyer in Williamsburg. And also, Chris Granis, thank you so much. From Haymarket, Virginia, thank you for streaming us online. Here's the Dorothy Roller family. And also Ken and Jill Stone and their whole family called in. And Carrie and Robert Lee and their kids in Williamsburg called in and wanted it to be known that they're celebrating tonight. Also, Marty and Carol Stern in Hollidaysburg. And here's one, Edward and LaDonna Biddle in memory of Sharon Biddle Emenheiser. Thank you so much for that great message. And also Ted and Ginger Michelone, or Michelone, I think that... Michelone, thank you. Lugene's helping us out over here with pronunciation. Also, Christy Haney, thank you so much. And Scott Bush and Tina Brantner, thank you so much. And here's, oh, this is a challenge. We love challenges. All right. Paul Gleim from Ohio called in and challenges the fire department. So there's a challenge to the fire department. All right, we've got one. All right, so let's hear from some of those firefighters. Also, we've got one from Sue and Mona Miller. I think that's from Sue and Mona, if I can read that. And also Larry Stevens in Alexandria. Thank you. In Alexandria, Pennsylvania. And we would love to hear from you next. I also want to show you guys the back of this DVD has about 26 folks on it who are telling tonight's stories. But beyond that is a long list of credits of all the folks who helped put the show together by collecting video and photos and just the support throughout the entire project. And then beyond that, everybody was calling in tonight to make this possible. And you are the next one at 1-800-245-9779. Right, Jessica?
That's right. I don't know. We apparently have the village people coming through one at a time live in studio this evening. So keep your eyes open here. And actually, on Twitter right now, Pastor Brian, there's a hashtag don't know Brian Detweiler. So anyway, though, but keep on tweeting. We love reading these tweets tonight that it seems like everybody is saying this. I really love my town and we love this town, too. This town has embraced us and we're happy to be able to bring you this and shows just like this with your support. So we have more folks we want to get to thank here. Thanks to Steve Luce of Indiana. Thank you so much for tuning in from Indiana, PA, I should clarify. Thanks to Mark Kiefer from Kiefer and Associates. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. Thanks to Joy McIntyre. I almost said Joey McIntyre, but I didn't. New Kids on the Block. Joe of my age. Of Williamsburg, thank you so much for your gift of support. Thanks to Matt and Tanya Sable. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. Thanks to Henry Warren of Ossining, New York. This is also from Diane England Warren. So thank you so much for your gift of support this evening. Thanks to John and Brenda Heil of Hollidaysburg. This is in honor of Lillian Heil. So thank you very much for that gift this evening. Thanks to Jeffrey Allender of Williamsburg in memory of Charles Allender. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. Thanks to Scott and Wendy Martin of Williamsburg. Thanks for calling in with your support tonight. To Laura Miller of Williamsburg. That's my mom's name. In memory of Sunny Miller. Thank you so much for your gift of support. Thanks to Barry, Gwen, Carly, Caitlin, Olivia, and Foster England of Williamsburg. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. Thanks to Don Appleman, who we saw back in the first segment. Don and Debbie Appleman in memory of their parents. Thank you so much, Mr. Appleman. Thanks to Richard and Deanna Parks of Williamsburg. Thank you so much for your gift. And thank you to Bill and Patty Riley of Williamsburg. Thank you so much. Thanks to everybody who's called in so far. Oh, I just heard a phone. There are a couple of phones that are open, so if you've been waiting, you haven't been able to get through, now would be a great time to give us a call at 1-800-245-9779. Remember, you can also make your gift online at WPSU.org. And don't forget to keep on tweeting us, hashtag OTWilliamsburg. We love seeing your tweets come in. Tell us why you love your town so much. 1-800-245-9779 is the number that you can call, though, to support great programming just like this. Kevin?
That's right, that's right. And Jessica made the reference a little while to the village people. You know, I'm thinking maybe we could come up with a song like WPSU. I don't know. Maybe we could do that. Show some blue pirate spirit tonight. I think we're all about that here at WPSU, and we're having a great time here in the studio. 1-800-245-9779 is the number to call to support your local public television station, WPSU, and great programming like you're seeing tonight, our town, Williamsburg. We have many thank yous to pass along. We have two anonymous thank yous, one to Hollidaysburg and one to Martinsburg. We thank you for calling in tonight. And I'd like to challenge some of the neighbors. You know, we've heard from Hollidaysburg, we've heard from Huntington tonight, but I don't know that I've heard from Bellwood or Tipton, Petersburg, Mill Creek, and I think Gannister is actually featured coming up. So we want to make sure maybe a few folks from there could call in tonight. Maybe a few of you already have. We referred to it as Williamsburg. Give us a call, 1-800-245-9779. We want to challenge you to do that. And we have lots and lots of thank yous. We want to get everybody's name on here tonight. We want to thank Angela Bilger of Tyrone, another neighbor calling in, David, Angela, Kyle, and Kayla Bilger for calling in. We want to thank Francis Walter, Francine and George and Brianna and Nate Walter for calling in from Christiana, Pennsylvania. We want to thank Clay Yeager, who's calling in memory of William Yeager. Thank you for calling in tonight. We want to thank Alan Kazina, Jesse, Josh, Peg, and Alan Kazina calling in tonight. We want to thank Heather Miller, who has a shout out for Josh, for Jason Rosser. A shout out for Jason Rosser tonight. We want to thank Kevin Eisenberg, who called in, Raymond and Bernadine Eisenberg and the whole Eisenberg family. Thank you for supporting your local public television station, WPSU. We want to thank Richard Talbert, also Williamsburg, for calling in. Richard, thank you. We want to thank Erica Lee of Huntington. Erica and Travis Lee, Huntington. There's one of those neighbors already calling in. Thank you very much. We want to thank Susan K. Smith calling in from Huntington. Susan Sollenberger Smith is calling in memory of Glenn and Viola Sollenberger and in honor of her brother Ron Sollenberger, who was a biology teacher, I'm guessing in Williamsburg, and in honor of her daughter Jen Wendland Gardner. So thank you for Gardner. Thank you for calling in tonight. Susan, we really appreciate it. And as I said earlier, I know a lot of these stories help bring back great memories of loved ones, and that's one of the beautiful things about this program. It inspires me. I know we did Clearfield recently, and I learned about how the coal mining was in the Clearfield area, and my grandfather was a coal miner in Clearfield, and so I really felt a connection with him, as I know many of you are doing tonight as you're watching our town, Williamsburg. We also want to thank Mary Catherine Eisenberg, who called in memory of her son, John Schaefer, and we also want to thank Marcia Williams, who called in memory of Betty Irvin, and in honor of Rusty Irvin. And guess what? They were graduates. Betty Irvin and Rusty Irvin were graduates of 1943. They were Blue Pirates, and they were high school sweethearts who were married 70 years. 70 years. So obviously a life well lived. So thank you, Marcia, for calling in and sharing that story with us tonight. And that's what we love about our town, Williamsburg. Your local public television station, WPSU, loves to tell the stories of the people here in central Pennsylvania. We love local programming, and we're asking you tonight to put a dollar value on that and give us a call at 1-800-245-9779 and say, I want to see more of that, and I'm willing to support it in the amount of whatever. If you give a gift of $75, we'll be glad to send you a DVD of the program tonight, and if you can step up that giving to $120, we'll be glad to send you two DVDs, one for you, one for a friend, and there's some great bonus features on there, some stories that just we couldn't fit into the program. There were so many wonderful stories about Williamsburg tonight. You are keeping us quite busy. There is one phone, and I'm hoping maybe Whitney can get an update on the number of calls, but I think she has a special guest, right?
Kevin, yeah. This is Gabe here, and you may have seen Gabe back working so hard in the background because he has been helping us out in the studio tonight.
Williamsburg, you have been so busy calling in, and we appreciate all of the great contributions to help stories like the ones that we're watching tonight come to life on air on WPSU. And Gabe has been running around collecting those forms, and I know he's got to get back to work, but he wanted to say hi to all of his friends in the Williamsburg community. So I know you got to get back to work, Gabe, so I won't keep you. I know you've been stressed out just standing up here waiting to wave, but tell everybody hi. Yay! All right, Gabe, you can go back. I know you really want to, but thank you. I just wanted to get him up here because I know he wanted to say hi, but we thank each and every person who has called in and put Gabe to work tonight. And now it's your turn to give us a call at 1-800-245-9779. And I've got some of those forms that Gabe has been picking up. Here's one from Jeremy and Robin Rupika. Thank you so much from Williamsburg for calling in their pledge of support tonight. Also, here's a special note to current mayor, Ted Heil, who we saw earlier. Thanks for keeping our town safe. And that's from Mr. Kurtz. Thank you to Mr. Kurtz for calling in that pledge. And also, here's a message. And this one just came in, and it was said it was in memory of great, great, great Jacob Ake and Wilmer Stultz. And that was from Hunter Ake in Altoona. Well, thank you, Hunter. Also, here's one from Melissa Merritt saying thank you to Riverside Park. Well, we heard about Riverside Park from Gabe's mom a little bit earlier. And here's one from Galen and Mary Beth. Thank you to Galen and Mary Beth. And this one is from the Randy and Twyla Bigelow family from Point View Farms in Williamsburg. And this one is from Margo Hazlett in Royer, class of 61, in memory of Creighton and Jesse Royer. Thank you so much for that pledge of support. And this is for former Lady Pirates Allison Edwards and Tori Mertiff. Thank you. Woo-hoo! From Penny Edwards. Oh, thank you. Yeah. This one is from Robin Eimler, Hunter, and Haley from Williamsburg. Also, Jay Hoover from Williamsburg. Thank you for calling in your pledge of support. And also, former Williamsburg High School teacher Harold Woodruff called in a pledge of support from State College. Thank you. And also, we heard from Harold, Tack, Karen, and Corey DeLozier in memory of parents Harold Sr. and Prusy and sister Donna Jean. Thank you so much. And also, Pastor Paul Campbell in memory of Chad Edmondson. Thank you so much. And we heard Shane Dixon's story earlier in the show. So that's such a nice pledge. Thank you so much. And also, Dick and Kathy Wilkinson in honor of their parents from Johnstown. And I think I had one more. Here's Denny Royer from California in memory of Creighton and Jesse Royer. Thank you so much. And this is in honor of the 225th anniversary of Williamsburg. So we appreciate that so much, and we're so excited to be celebrating that in 2015. And we heard that from Tim Tate. You're the next one we want to thank at 1-800-245-9779. There's Tim right there. And that $75 pledge gets you a copy of tonight's program on DVD. But more important than buying that DVD, you're celebrating your hometown stories and supporting this program and all of the stories, the local stories on public television. 1-800-245-9779. Right, Jessica?
Absolutely right. And you know, we all have a connection to each other somehow. And this next person that I'm going to thank, I found out we were connected in ways we didn't even know. So, next story you're going to see when we go back to the show is Chris Brown. Chris and I were just having a chat for Shannon for her interview, and we were talking about she was a teacher, and she had a cousin that was a teacher in Snowshoe, PA. I said, oh, really? I'm a pen pal for a class in Snowshoe, PA. Who's your cousin? And she said, Ann Houck. And I went, no way. That's my pen pal. We have been pen pals with each other. I've been a pen pal for her class for the last 5 years or so. She's watched my daughter grow up, and we've become very dear friends. And it just goes to show that we are all connected, and we all must have that blue pirate blood running through our veins one way or another. It was a really cool thing. So special thank you to Ann and Bruce Houck of Snowshoe. This is also in memory of Chip and Ethel Houck and Bob and Vela Tate. So thank you so much for your gift this evening. Hi, Ann. Thanks to Richard and Alberta McLean of Williamsburg. Thank you so much for your gift of support. thanks to John Crouch of Williamsburg. This is in memory of Pauline Grove and Paul Grove, I believe that says. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. Thanks to Doug, Yvette, Yvonne, Victoria, and Victoria Catherine Longnecker. There we go. Of Williamsburg. Sorry about that. Thank you so much for your gift of support. Thank you to David and Sherry Ross and family of Williamsburg. Thank you so much for your gift this evening. Thanks to Randy Edwards and Jean Slott, is that, I believe, from Camp Hill. Thank you so much for your gift of support. Thanks to John and Joan Lear of Williamsburg. Thank you for calling in with your support this evening. And thank you to Mel and Sandy Shanafelt in memory of their son, Todd. And they are from Tyrone. Those are just a couple of the people that have called in this evening. We would encourage you to give us a call. There are some phones that are open. I know, it's not going to last long. So call in quickly, 1-800-245-9779. We are going to be going back to the program momentarily. So if you haven't been able to get through and you're just like, oh my goodness gracious, write down the number, 1-800-245-9779, and give us a call whenever the show starts, because usually the phones slow down a little bit then. Or you can always go online to WPSU.org. But we'd love to be able to thank you tonight on air and show you how much we care about your gift to us, in acknowledgement of how much you care about programming like this right here on your public TV station, WPSU. Kevin?
You know, the barber said 9 out of 10 people in Williamsburg are happy there. I would argue it's 10 out of 10 people, because I'll tell you, this is a fun crowd, and I haven't met one bad egg in the bunch yet. So, and you folks that are calling in tonight are just as supportive. In fact, we have a couple that's watching from Northport, Florida, that are watching the live stream right now, and they are in enjoying the program, so we wanted to give a shout out to you. And you can follow us at hashtag OutTownOTWilliamsburg. You can see it up there. No, over there. Yeah, you can see it right there. So follow us, send us a tweet. We would love to hear from you if you're watching the program tonight. 1-800-245-9779 is the number to call. We have a lot of thank yous to get to. I'm going to try and do them here really quickly. We have Mary Ann Over, who's calling in from Williamsburg. Mary, thank you. We have Mary Lou Link of Duncansville, who's calling in. Brian and Mary Lou Link of Duncansville calling in honor of Tom and Diane Salt. I believe I pronounced that correctly. Richard and Dawn Talbert and Destiny and Dakota calling in. We have Julie Uplinger of Williamsburg. Aaron, Julie, Adam, Taylor, Luke, and Ty Uplinger calling in. We have Christina Bratton of Williamsburg. Kirk, Tina, Ross, and Emma Bratton. Thank you for calling in. And we have Rosie Johnson of Martinsburg, PA. Paul and Rosie Johnson of Martinsburg calling in. So thank you. Thank you for your support of your local public television station, WPSU. I encourage you, if you haven't been a member before and you're watching this program and you're thinking this is really cool, it is really cool. You know, we've been seeing on the tweet feed tonight that this program is really cool. And we appreciate that. So it's really cool to work with the community of Williamsburg. And you know what? I think, and I'll say this myself, our public television station, WPSU, is a really cool public television station, and we make a great partnership. So thank you. And if you can put a dollar value on that, give us a call at 1-800-245-9779. I know Whitney has more thank yous, so I'm going to toss it over there. Whitney.
I do. Kevin and Gretchen Easter from Williamsburg, thank you so much for calling in and being a part of tonight's show. We are going back to the show in just a minute. We had an anonymous gift from Martinsburg. You know who you are. Thank you so much for being a part of tonight's celebration of Williamsburg. Also, we had one in memory of the Lichens from Tony and Shelley Rispoli. Thank you so much. And here's one from Jeff and Peggy Corey from Bellwood, another Our Town program that we recently produced that we had so many great stories from. Also, here's one from Joe White from Williamsburg. Thank you. And Haley, Allie, and Chloe England Fry. Thank you. And that's from the Fries. Thank you so much. We also had one from Phyllis Grosch in memory of their grandfather, Tony Fay, who owned a homemade ice cream store on 2nd Street in the 1940s. Thank you so much. And we had one from the Millers in memory of Bob Miller, 6th grade teacher for 33 years, and daughter Keith Lorene Miller. Thank you. We're going back to the show in just seconds, but there's time for you to call at 1-800-245-9779 and get your own copy of Our Town Williamsburg and make that contribution for $75. But there are more stories from your friends and neighbors. Stay tuned. Write that phone number down, because you can call during the program.
But get ready, because your friends and neighbors are sharing some great stories from your hometown, Williamsburg.
You can also make your pledge at WPSU.org. Click on Contribute at the top of the page. It's always available and easy to use. Thanks.
My name's Christina Brown, and I'm actually a 1984 graduate of Williamsburg High School, and I would like to share some stories today about my grandfather, William S. Rhodes. My grandfather grew up in Gannister, which is a small community just outside of Williamsburg, and yeah, he did have it rough in those days, you know, during the Depression times. Money was scarce, and things didn't come as easily as they do today. He went through school as an athlete and a scholar. He was offered scholarship to university, and he was able to fulfill that scholarship until he had a concussion. He did finish that semester, but then came back home to work, and people around Williamsburg would know the quarries. So he worked in the quarries and worked very hard at it. During that time, the war was approaching. What I'm told that he said was he might as well pick the Navy because he liked the water and he could swim. He was called a frogman. At those times, that would be considered Navy SEALs of today. The story that my grandmother tells is there were two sunken Japanese barges, and his convoy had to swim through them, and as they were swimming, they were being shot at entirely until they reached the shore. So I guess he was termed Boston Bill of the Pacific, and his group was the most shot at group that swam. After the war, he continued his education at Dickinson and did receive his bachelor's degree there. And then between Michigan University and Penn State University, he received his master and then furthered on to his doctorate degree. He wanted to surprise my grandmother for a wedding anniversary and take her to Hawaii. And the reason he picked Hawaii was not because of the paradise. It was because that's where he trained as a frogman, and he wanted her to see what Maui was like and what he had learned there. While he was there, he had a heart attack. So his 3-week vacation turned into a 3-month episode. I do know lots of people had him in their thoughts and prayers, and I got lots of postcards from Hawaii during that time. When someone's in trouble, now surely we know what our neighbors are doing. That is one thing that might be true with small town. But we also know that when our neighbors are in trouble, we can help them out, and we work through it that way. We're good problem solvers whenever it comes down to finding ways to help others or ways to better ourselves.
My name's Don Dietz. I'm here to talk about Royer Mansion. Royer Mansion is sort of a local landmark. It's about 5 miles south of town. A big stone house that the Royer family lived in for about 150 years. Samuel Royer, he was an iron master. He ran an iron furnace here, which is Springfield Furnace. He built the property in 1815. Since he had 14 kids, he put a large addition onto the house. And the house as it is today is pretty much the way he left it. It currently belongs to the Blair County Historical Society. They're responsible for it. I live on the second floor, so I'm sort of the site manager. We have events there as fundraisers, and brings a little life to the place. Our most successful ones involve food. You know, if you have food, people will come. We had a nice candlelight tea. We had a nice Victorian tea. And we always had Christmas dinners. We had a pig roast. The teddy bear picnic was something we did for the kids. It was sort of a kid's picnic, and they all brought their teddy bears, and just a fun time for the kids.
This is the spring house on the Royer Mansion property. It's a two-story limestone building.
George Dempsey is one of the locals. He grew up in Williamsburg, and actually, if it wasn't for George, Royer Mansion might just be a pile of stones because it sat empty for a while. And when George was 13, he got started writing letters and getting people concerned about saving the mansion. So George deserves a lot of credit for its present state of preservation. It's supposed to be haunted. There are all kinds of stories about the spirits that live there. I've had several paranormal groups come in to investigate. The story I get basically is that there's an older woman there who looks after the place, which we think is probably Carrie Hartman, who was the last of the Royer family to live there. She died in the 60s. There are two or three mischievous children. That seems to be an undetermined number. And then supposedly there's a mean man who doesn't like the kids. I don't, you know, take that for what it's worth. We are open for tours. We don't really have regular hours. So if anybody's interested, they could take a chance and just stop by. Or if you're coming any distance, I would say be better off to call and set something up. I've always been interested in architecture, especially 19th century architecture. They were looking for new tenants, and my friend George says, "Don, do you want to live there?" Well, it took me about 6 seconds to decide. I'm an artist, so I have a little painting studio set up out there, and in warm weather, I just spend a lot of time out on the porch.
My name's Father Aaron Magsudi, and I am, for the past 4 years, pastor of St. Joseph's Church here in Williamsburg. St. Joseph's Parish really has its origins in the year 1830. Now, in 1830, Bishop Kenrick, then Father Hughes, later Archbishop Hughes, they bought a lot of land, which is the lot that the church sits on to this day. In 1861, the parish was officially organized, and it was always small. The early people in that parish, by and large, not exclusively, were Irish. The original church building was built in 1861, and that would serve as the parish church until 1973. Beginning in the early 20th century, you start to see quarries opening up in the area around Williamsburg. A lot of the immigrants that came here to work mostly in the quarries would have been a Croatian, Italian, and some other Slavic people who would have come from what was then the Austro-Hungarian Empire. Today, 3/4 of the parishioners are descendants of those immigrant families that came. And I think that's what makes our parish rich and great. I mean, it's part of our parish culture, it's a rich heritage. But when it comes down to it, as much as we're rooted in our past, one of the things that you see is a great sense of love and community support. And that's so important. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Williamsburg is the quintessential American small town. I mean, really and truly. It's sort of self-sufficient. It has its own high school. It has its own churches. It sort of has its own culture, if you will. It's surrounded by a great deal of natural beauty. In that sense, that great American ideal of the demi-paradise as this wonderful place or idyllic place to live really plays itself out in Williamsburg. You have all different kinds of personalities, and some of these families have been here forever. But you also have new people who move into this area, and they all together make up the great fabric that is this community, and it's something to really be proud of.
I'm Cheryl Hughes. I'm here to talk about Dorothy Kuntz, whom I met when I went to Williamsburg High School to work in 1968.
The house is right there on that raised place.
Mm-hmm.
Where was the front door facing? That way?
Mm-hmm. My classroom was right next to her office, so I saw a lot of her. She wore 6 or 8 different hats. One of them was in charge of supplies, so whenever I ran out of paper, I went next door and she went and got me paper out of the supply closet. I saw a lot of her, and I'd stop in between classes and talk to her. She had been there since 1937 or 8, working initially as a school board secretary for the district, for the borough, for the townships. She was a superintendent secretary. She did all of those things by herself in that office next door. A remarkable lady, very pleasant, always cheerful and smiling, very efficient, very capable lady. We went to visit Dorothy in her apartment because she retired in 2010, after 67 years, I think.
You had to iron your grandmother's drawers?
Yes. They were made out of either, I think, flour sacks or sugar sacks, you know, they used, and they would lay them out in the sun to bleach whatever wording was on them.
And then they'd wear them as drawers?
Well, they cut them with a pattern, and they didn't just hang there.
That sounds scratchy.
No, they were...
Everyone in town knows Dorothy Kuntz. She knows everyone in town. She's one of those people that has just always been there. Before I came here for my interview in 1968, I had never been here. And I think I would have said at that time that I was not interested in living in a small town. But I have since grown to appreciate the community, the support. There are a lot of good things about living in a small town.
John Ashman, I'm here to tell you about the farm we purchased, why we came to Williamsburg, and what we've done with the farm in the past 40-some years that we've lived there. I had just finished a master's degree at Syracuse, and I wanted to raise our family in a bucolic setting. I wanted them on a farm. I was raised in a city, and I had enough of that. So shortly after we came here, the farm that we now have came up for sale. And with the help of my father, who was a horseman before me, he helped us buy that farm. And we started a project that would last 40 years in remodeling the farm. The farm had plumbing, and the farm had electricity, but it had no modern heat. It had no finished cellar floor. It had no insulation. A fellow came to me, and he was a plumber, and he wanted me to break a horse for him. And he said, "You can't afford my wages. Ride my horse 2 months, I'll put the heat in." So that's how we got heat. We bartered it off. When I was a young man, I judged, I gave riding lessons, I broke horses, and I sold them. I just had this consuming desire to breed horses. So we expanded from just one stallion and four mares to where we eventually had nearly 20 mares, and we were shipping horses literally across the country to people anywhere from cowboys, college professors, and movie stars. I taught here for 30 plus years. Some of my kids, though, the ones that I've worked with in the past, have developed excellent horse businesses and have been very successful in the show ring. So that farm has kept us socially active, it's kept us physically active, it's kept us mentally active as we constantly think about next year's fall crop, how to make it better. It's a quiet area, too. It's beautiful. People will come to our place from literally from Texas or wherever, and they'll say, "This place is beautiful." You go through Williamsburg and get into the cove, and that valley opens up, and the great beauty that's there. Many people will remark how beautiful this area is.
My name's Carly Rinaldi, and I'm here to talk about the Williamsburg Women's Civic Club. The Civic Club was formed in 1947, and their goal was to establish a public library in town as well as a nursery school. They formed a nursery school in 1947, which led to the half-day kindergarten in 1970 that was started within the school. And in 1950, they opened the public library in our community. Today, the Civic Club's very active in the community. One of the big projects is the community improvement and beautification, where we do the flower pots downtown. Someone during the summer is always out watering them, so it takes a lot to maintain them, but we take it very seriously. Every year before Easter, we partner with the Lions Club to have a community Easter egg hunt where several hundred kids come and participate. We sponsor a story hour in town that happens at the library, and we have members that read stories to the preschool children and do some activities with them. We also do the community birthday calendar, which is a great fundraiser for us, but also something fun for the community. So we sell names for birthdays, anniversaries, and memorials for on the calendar. So every day you're able to look at your calendar and see, you know, whose birthday is today in the community, or who should be remembered, or someone's anniversary. So it's very, very nice. I moved to town in January of 2009, and shortly after, my neighbor, who was an active Civic Club for many years, Grace Stoltz, asked me if I'd be interested in attending one of the meetings. So I attended a meeting and really enjoyed it, so I joined the next month. We have approximately 40 members in the Civic Club right now, varying ages, but mostly older women in the community. It's very important to get younger people involved in these types of organizations because the older members have started something great that we really need to continue. My husband grew up in the community. We moved here for family reasons. I decided if this was the community where children were going to be raised and we were going to make a home, that it would be important to make sure that it was the best community it could be. So I've taken an active role in many of the organizations in the town, such as the Civic Club. I'm also the president of Borough Council and part of the Friends of the Library and many other organizations in town. It's a great community to raise your children because there's lots of activities, lots of sports, lots of things for them to do, but it's also a very small community where we all know each other. We all, for the most part, get along and enjoy, you know, getting out and talking to each other at the kids' games and serving on different organizations with each other. This may not have started as my home, but it has become our home.
Stories from Williamsburg continue as we reminisce with the alumni band, learn about the rich history of the iron furnaces in the area, and take a trip to Penn England Farm. Now, show your support for Williamsburg and WPSU by making a pledge. Thanks.
Hi, thanks for tuning in to Our Town Williamsburg. We've got a raucous crowd of people from Williamsburg tonight taking your pledges at 1-800-245-9779. Now, I've been asked to give a big shout-out to the football team, who are 2-0 for the first time starting the season in a long time. And they play Glendale tomorrow night, so we're hoping that, you know, wish them well. We don't want to wish any other teams in our coverage area poorly, but, you know, it's Williamsburg tonight, okay? 1-800-245-9779. By the way, I'm not really here. I'm redshirting. 1-800-245-9779. Thanks to Ann Michelone of Duncansville in memory of Ted and Barbara Michelone. Thank you very much for that. We heard from A Reason to Run in Williamsburg, a local running group in Williamsburg. Also, Alton and Luann Heilman of Williamsburg in loving memory of Ken Lynn and Bill Rhodes, and also Joe and Tiffany Marvich of Williamsburg. All these people calling in and making their pledge, thank you very much. We'll be back to the show. There's a lot more to come. You haven't seen the whole show yet, but call your phone, your friends here from Williamsburg at 1-800-245-9779. If you had trouble getting through, now's your opportunity to make a call. Joining me in the studio, Kevin Conaway.
Hey, Greg, thank you. You know what struck me about that last story on the Women's Civic Club was the calendar where you could have your community members' birthdays and their anniversaries. I mean, what kind of community has that, where you can flip through a calendar and know the birthdays and the anniversary of your neighbors? What a wonderful, significant sign of what a wonderful community Williamsburg is. And I just really enjoyed that. I found that really striking. And we would like you to join our calendar here at WPSU and become a member. Be part of the community that supports public television. And you can do that very simply by calling one of these wonderful folks from Williamsburg. 1-800-245-9779 is the number to call. And we have many thank yous to pass along tonight. We want to thank Tim Tate, and the Sheldon Tate family, who was featured in the program tonight. We want to thank George Dempsey of Williamsburg, Pennsylvania. And George called in. George actually made the pledge in memory of his parents, Lou and Marion Dempsey. So thank you. Both of them are phone volunteers tonight. So thank you very much. And they're busy on the phones right now. We want to thank Gordon Lynn of Hollidaysburg and Lynn's Country Creamery calling in. Boy, some ice cream would be good right now because it's a little hot in the studio tonight. But we would appreciate that. Tina Marie Lynn of Williamsburg calling in. Mike and Tina Lynn and children, Logan, Roy, and Marcella calling in. We want to thank them. We want to thank Christy Detweiler of Roaring Springs, Pennsylvania. She's calling in memory of Fanny Robley. So thank you, Christy, for calling in. We want to thank Rose Lynn, Richard and Rose Lynn of Williamsburg. Thank you for calling in tonight. And we want to thank John and Nancy Fry of Williamsburg. They're calling in memory of Clarence Fry, who retired from the Williamsburg paper mill. And that story is actually coming up next, so you're going to want to check that out. And that was a story done by Sheldon Smokey Tate. And I'm interested to get the story behind his nickname. And Whitney and I have discovered on a lot of these Our Town pieces that there's a lot of interesting nicknames throughout central Pennsylvania. So I challenge you to call in and tell us some of the cool nicknames that are in the Williamsburg area. So 1-800-245-9779 is the number to call. I'm going to get right over to Whitney because we have many thank yous to pass along tonight. Whitney.
We do have many folks to thank, and we want to let everyone know that we want to thank every single person because it's all of these folks and you that make programs like this possible on your local public TV station. When you go to the phone and call 1-800-245-9779, because every contribution matters. Every
everyone makes a difference and goes to pay for programs and the local programs, especially here on WPSU. It makes local stories possible, like the Our Town series. It was such a privilege to work with all these folks that you see here on the phones in the studios. They're your friends and neighbors that told all these stories, that gathered the video and gathered the photos, and it's all of their work that's coming to life on screen tonight. So call 1-800-245-9779 or log on to WPSU.org and make your gift that way. A $75 contribution. We'd love to send you a copy of tonight's program on DVD, and that has some great bonus features. We might show you a little clip of those later, just a snippet. $120 contribution, and we would love to send you two of those DVDs. But remember, it's not buying a copy of the DVD. It's making a contribution to help support the programs and your public TV station. Now, I've got a great thank you here, a great message. This one is in memory of Carl A. Schultz, the auctioneer, for the many donations he made to the farm show through auctions, also over a lifetime of butchering over 8,000 deer for friends in the community in Williamsburg. And also thank you for the many prayers from the Williamsburg community for their daughter, Lori Schultz Everts, who is fighting right now from bone cancer. So thank you so much. And that comes from Wayne Schultz and family in Williamsburg. So thank you, Wayne. And we hope that you and your family, and we wish you all the best right now. And our thoughts are with you and your family. And also this one is from Bill Over in Leesburg, Virginia, in memory of Glendale and Larry Over. That's a great one too. Thank you so much for calling in tonight. And this one is from Anna Gunnett in Williamsburg. And Anna says, memories of high school class of 1952. Three boys and three girls also calling in. Thank you so much. And this one is from Harold W. Stoltz, 1968 graduate of Williamsburg High School, four generations native Williamsburg, and grandnephew of Wilmer Stoltz and Flew Amelia Earhart. And yes, that's great. And this one's from East Freedom. Thank you so much. So great legacy there in Williamsburg. And here's one of in memory of Shelley Marvich Mills, and this is from Steve and Jenny Booker. Thank you so much for making your contribution. This one's in memory of Bonnie Barry and Mark Kiefer in Williamsburg, and that's from Michael Kiefer. And also Dave and Billy Joe Greaser and family, thank you so much for being a part of tonight's show. And Jeff Kipe, in memory of Don Kipe, an avid trail walker, thank you so much. And Mike Dillon from Altoona, thank you for being part of tonight's show. We want to hear from you next at 1-800-245-9779 or on the web at WPSU.org. And also, big thanks to the folks at Otto's in State College for supplying food for our volunteers and keeping them going tonight. So give us a call and be a part of tonight's show, 1-800-245-9779. Right, Greg?
Right, you are, Whitney. 1-800-245-9779. Our phone volunteers, our lovely phone volunteers, you're too low. They can't see. Did you see that? I've been photobombed again. 1-800-245-9779. Call and make your pledge. Or go online to WPSU.org. We had a lot of people who have been going to our website to make the pledge because the phone's been so busy. We like to say hi to Dick Buckley, who lives now in Kane but taught in the school district for many years. Then he moved up to Kane. And also Richard Showalter from Altoona. Linda, security guard, see you tomorrow. I'm not sure what that means. Okay, they know it. It's inside joke. Also from Gloria, also known as Jeannie Brown, who now lives in Greensboro, North Carolina. Well, thank you very much, Jeannie, for calling in, watching tonight. Also from Richard Tate in Williamsburg. What? Who? Yes, it's 3rd Street, yeah. In honor of Bob and Mary Mingle from Rich and Donna Tate, Bob and Vala Tate. Also, word for Ken Rinaldi II, which I guess means Ken Rinaldi II, in memory of Vito Rinaldi. Thank you very much, Ken, for that pledge. Also from Paula Ford and Craig Cameron, a gift in honor of their dear friends from Zion Lutheran Church in Williamsburg, and in memory of Mrs. Edna Elda Henderson, who was like an extra grandmother in the family. Well, thank you very much. Richard Wyant from Dick and Leota Wynette, Williamsburg High School class of 1968. Salute. Brenda and Troy Albright at Williamsburg making a web pledge. Also, the incomparable Paisley and Dieters in Williamsburg. They're incomparable, whoever they are, but they made a pledge. And also Deborah Fisher of Hollidaysburg making a pledge. Thank you all very much for calling in and making a pledge at 1-800-245-9779. Or a lot of people went on the web at WPSU.org. There's no waiting there. Sometimes the phones get busy, but you can make your transaction there. For a $75 pledge, we can send you a copy of the show you're watching tonight, Our Town, Williamsburg. And there's extra bonus footage on there with Dorothy Coons and William Kramer. For $120, we can send you two copies of the show, Our Way of Saying Thanks. Give us a call. Talk to our phone volunteers from Williamsburg. We're here raising the money it takes to purchase, produce, and broadcast the programs on WPSU. So your dollar right now is a pledge we're looking for. Kevin?
That's right, Greg. And Greg just mentioned the thank you gift, the Our Town Williamsburg DVD. A gift of $75 gets you one of those. A gift of $120 gets you both of those. And it's really just our way of saying thank you for supporting WPSU, your local public television station, WPSU. And there is some bonus footage that you're only going to see on this DVD. You're not going to see it here on the air tonight. And we're going to take a look at just a little bit of that right now. 92 and Fabulous was the last story. Here's some of that bonus footage.
Now, she didn't have an ironing board. She, not the kind that, you know, that collapses, you know, and you pull. She just put it on the table, the kitchen table. But the thing that we always laughed about was she called them her drawers. Mm-hmm. And
we had an art teacher, Mr. Kramer, and Mr. William Kramer, and he was very strong in the Historical Society of Williamsburg, and he collected a lot of things and he shared a lot of things.
And we had a really nice tweet here from Wendy Martin saying, I miss Mr. Kramer so much. He's a big, sorry, I ducked down on there. He's a big reason Williamsburg has so much history. So thank you, Wendy. And you can see Mr. Kramer was a great person in the Williamsburg community and very much honored. And I tell you, that Dorothy Coontz, you know, Betty White is 91 and Fabulous, but Dorothy Coontz is 92 and Fabulous. She's got one up on Betty White. 1-800-245-9779 is the number to call. And we have many thank yous to pass along, and we invite you to become the next person to support your local public television station, WPSU. We have one phone, and it just rang, so just be patient, 1-800-245-9779. We want to thank Rowdy Kagaris, Sage, Sawyer, Tanner, and Ryder, and I believe they're all grandchildren, and forgive me if I'm wrong on the name there, but Rowdy, that might be one of those nicknames I was talking about a little earlier. We want to thank, and they're all of Williamsburg, we want to thank Brian Detweiler of Williamsburg for making a pledge tonight. We also want to thank Wendy Rosser of Williamsburg for making a pledge tonight to their local public television station, your local public television station, WPSU. We want to thank Julia Ferreso of Williamsburg, both Jim and Julia Ferreso. We want to thank Rich and Nancy Luke of Williamsburg, Pennsylvania. Thank you for your pledge of support. We want to thank Joe and Anna Mae Vary, also of Williamsburg. Thank you for your pledge of support. We want to thank Cindy Michelone, and I will get that name right tonight, and I think you're challenging me, of Homer City, Pennsylvania, Jerry and Cindy Michelone. Thank you so much for calling in your pledge of support. We also want to thank Amy Holensick of Hollidaysburg. Mike and Amy called in memory of Willis and Esther Treese tonight. Thank you for your call. And Barry Weiland in memory of Whitney and Brian Weiland. Thank you so much. The whole Weiland family calling in. We really appreciate it. We also want to thank Jacqueline England who called in from the Aberdeen Proving Ground. Ethan, Jackie, Regan, Abby, and Zachary England. Thank you all for calling in. We really appreciate it. And we want to thank Richard Eugene Norris, Dick and Sandy Norris calling in from Williamsburg. More Third Street. I'm telling you, I think Third Street might be winning Williamsburg. I got to tell you. You know, we want to hear from first. We want to hear from second. We'll see what else we hear, but I think they may be winning. 1-800-245-9779. If you're on Third Street, won't you be the next call? 1-800-245-9779. Whitney.
So, Becky Mingle said I got to be the one to say that the Blue Pirates were undefeated two games already in the season. And then Greg, announce it, but I'm going to do it again already. So I know the Blue Pirates can have an undefeated season. Linda Smith is over there going, yeah. All right, Blue Pirates, you got it. So call in your Blue Pirate pride right now and be a part of Williamsburg Night here on WPSU. We know those Blue Pirates got it. So come on, 1-800-245-9779. I also got a couple of really cool tweets here. This one says, woohoo, Carly, she has done great things for Williamsburg and a really cool ninja friend. Shout out to Carly. That's right, shout out to Carly. We know Carly's got so much going on in Williamsburg, and she could not be with us tonight, but she was a huge support throughout the entire project, and we heard a story in the last segment. We also have, we had a pledge in memory of Vito Rinaldi, so we wanted to be sure to mention that on air. So thank you so much for these comments, and keep those tweets coming, and you see that hashtag up in the corner of your screen. We also want to be sure to thank Gary Dukovich, who wants to thank our town for featuring his house on the DVD. So thank you, Gary, for calling in your contribution tonight. And you can get a copy of tonight's program on DVD when you call in and make your contribution at 1-800-245-9779. And there you see Gary's house right there on the cover of the DVD. Thank you, Gary, for being a part of tonight's program and supporting our town Williamsburg as well. And there we also heard from Michelle and Mark Caitlin and Welch in Williamsburg. Thank you so much for being a part of tonight's show. And also Patty Hatch from Williamsburg. Thank you so much. And from the former Friends of the Royer Committee, thank you so much for being a part of tonight's program. And also here's Becky Mingle, and Becky's here in the studio with us. And she's got Gabe running around, and Gabe did have a cool hat on earlier, but I'm sure you've spotted that already. Also, Jim Becker and family, thanks to the Becker family. And here's one from Anna Crouch in memory of David Crouch from Anna and her and the Crouch family. Thank you so much. And also Dale Tracy, Zach West, and Tyler McCall, thank you so much for being a part of the show tonight. And here's one from Terry and Trent and Jamie and Tyler and Janet Lee. Thank you so much. And Bob and Arlene McCall, more McCall family. And Jim and Carol Price and their three sons and three grandchildren. We want to hear from you next. 1-800-245-9779. More stories from Williamsburg coming your way, we promise, but there's room for your call at 1-800-245-9779. Right, Greg?
That's right, Whitney. Lest you forget, for a pledge of $75 or more, we can send you a DVD copy of the show with some of the bonus features that Kevin talked about earlier in this break. $120, we can send you two copies. Keep one, send one away, our way of saying thanks for your support of your public TV station, WPSU. That's who we are. We're here raising the funds it takes to purchase, produce, and broadcast programs that you watch on WPSU, Our Town Williamsburg. In fact, the entire Our Town project has been a great way for us to connect with the communities that we serve throughout central Pennsylvania on a daily basis. Thanks to Josh Kazina, in memory of J. Alfred Biddle from Williamsburg. Thank you very much. Also, John Shakaria and Ava Dixon from Williamsburg. Thank you very much. Travis McCall, East Freedom, Pennsylvania, in memory of Charles Allender and Louise Strum. And also, let's see, Jill Liebal of Williamsburg, in memory of Kim Detweiler and Shelley Marvich Mills, I'm sorry. And also, Priscilla Bumgardner, Williamsburg. Glenn and Priscilla Bumgardner, in memory of Glenn and Naomi Bumgardner, who owned and operated the GB Electric in Williamsburg for many years. Well, thank you all very much for those pledges. 800-245-9779. We got more people to thank. We want to get to that right now. Kev?
Absolutely. We have a lot of thank yous to pass along. We want to thank Bob and Kathy Hearn, who called in memory of Galen and Alberta Hearn. And now this is really interesting. Galen was the last one to ring the shift bell at the paper mill before it closed. And that's actually the very next story coming up when we return to the program is all about the paper mill. It's really a fascinating story. It's told by Sheldon Smokey Tate, and you're going to really enjoy it. So you're going to want to stick around for that. We have a lot of great stories still coming up for our town, Williamsburg. And that's the football coach, I'm told. Right, Whitney?
Yes.
Yeah. And this is the year. Right?
This is the year.
absolutely. Blue pirate spirit we have. And we learned so much about the wonderful sports teams throughout our town, Williamsburg, tonight. We learned about the state champ basketball teams that they've had over the years. And it's really a small school, so it's really impressive. It's one of the smallest schools in Pennsylvania, so it's really impressive with all these great things that they are doing. And I tell you what, our town, Williamsburg, is really impressing me tonight. It's a wonderful community. It's great people. And we're really impressed with the support that you're showing for your local public television station, WPSU. And let's do some of those thank yous right now. We want to thank Rex Metz of Williamsburg, who called in. Rex has lived there 40 years. And Rex, I hate to say this, but that's as long as I've been live. Sorry, gotta tell you that, Rex. Michelle Weiss is calling in. Michelle of Williamsburg. Michelle, that's great. Chelsea Rhodes, also of Williamsburg, calling in. And Rick Brown of Williamsburg. And we also want to thank Ken and Kay Claybaugh of Williamsburg. Thank you for calling in. I do believe we are getting really close to saying the name of every person in Williamsburg tonight, but if you haven't called in...
Well, only 10%.
Well, only 10%, but it's 10 out of 10 people are happy in Williamsburg, right? Isn't that the way... 9.7, that's the way it goes. So we want to get your name on here if we haven't heard from you tonight, because I tell you what, everyone in Williamsburg is going to be talking about this tomorrow at the football game, and if you didn't do it, you know, you're going to miss out. Right, Whitney?
Yes.
Oh, right. Wait.
And, you know, I don't know how Gabe is grabbing those forms with those boxing gloves on his hands. Like, how is he that working out? But you know what? The phones are a little quiet right now, and perhaps that's why he can wear those boxing gloves on his hands. Maybe so. I don't know. Maybe that's why he can put those on there. But I also have to give a shout-out to Brian Detweiler and his crazy outfits. And he happened to bring in those crazy outfits that Gabe's wearing over there. So if you want to give a shout out to these crazy outfits, give us a call, 1-800-245-9779. But give us a call to support great stories from your hometown here on our town, Williamsburg. Stories from your friends and neighbors. And there you see Brian in his crazy outfit on the phone over there. And this shout out comes courtesy of Chris Weidig, and it's from Tony and Tammy Detweiler and Scott and Chris Weidig and family. And unfortunately, he's over there on the phone right now, but I told him he had one coming his way. And this one is from Cheryl White in honor of Lenore Rhodes' wife and Bill Rhodes by Terry and Cheryl White. Thank you so much for that call. And this one is from Dave Force in Indiana. Dave and Susie Force and their boys in Indiana want to say hi to all their family and friends in Williamsburg. Thank you so much. And also Chris and Pam House in memory of Richard and Bertha Schultz. Thank you so much for that call. And also John Evans, class of 66, in memory of Keller and Violet Evans. We're going back to the show in just seconds, but there's room for you to call and make that contribution of support to get a copy of tonight's program on DVD and $75 contribution. Remember, there's bonus footage on there, but the important thing is to support stories from your hometown here on our town, Williamsburg. Support stories that you love from your friends and neighbors. More stories coming your way. Write that phone number down. You can make a call. Make your contribution. More from Williamsburg right now, and thanks.
You can also make your pledge at WPSU.org. Click on Contribute at the top of the page. It's always available and easy to use. Thanks.
I'm Sheldon Tate. I'm here to talk about the paper mill at Williamsburg. It was located where the envelope company's buildings are, plus the big lot behind it. It started out as West Virginia Pulp and Paper Company, then later on it became Westvaco. The paper mill started in 1903. I worked at the paper mill. I started in 42, and then 43 I went to the service. I come back in 46 and worked there till 75 when it shut down. My dad worked with me there and two brothers. I started as an oiler. I worked in the chlorine. I worked in the lab, both labs, pulp lab and paper lab. You know, I worked labor for a while. And it ended in 1975. They built a new mill in Kentucky, and it could make twice as much paper with one machine as we could make with both of ours here. Most of us got jobs around this area at other things. I went from paper mill to Berwyn White Railway in Aldersburg. My service days, I was everywhere in other countries and cities and stuff in America. This is as good as any.
I'm Cindy England. I'm going to talk about penning on farm. My husband and I both were born on farms and grew up on farms. Our families came from farms in the area. We milked 2,000 cows on three separate locations. We also farmed 2,600 acres of cropland, mostly with alfalfa hay and corn, which we feed to the cows. We love to have field trips from area schools and from preschools, Head Start, and the kids love to see the animals. We love to tell them how we take care of the animals, you know, how the milk is produced, and they just, so many of them have never seen a calf or touched a calf, and they think it's wonderful. As part of the conservation practices, we use a GPS system to monitor our fields. And whenever we're doing a soil fertility test, we map the fields using the GPS system. And that way, when we come back in the spring and we need to put fertilizer on, we only put fertilizer on at the correct amounts. And that way, we're not putting extra nutrients on the ground, which could be leached out or washed out and not used and could end up in rivers too. We also have a methane digester, which we use to produce electricity. The manure from the cows is pumped into a tank, and the tank has a cover over it. And while it is in this tank, it ferments and it produces methane. The electricity we produce in one day, which we use for our barns and we put back into the grid, would be enough to run 90 average homes in one day. We help the community helps us. People know each other and they care for each other. When there's a problem, they normally come together and will help each other.
My name's Michael Maritz. I'm talking primarily, I guess, about the alumni band. I listened to a lot of music when I was a child. My sister would play the radio, and so like late 70s, in the early 80s, I would get to hear a lot of that music. So I grow up loving music, wanting to be a part of it. We, of course, have the options for that here in our town. We have the band, we have, any church has a choir in it if you attend the church. I started in fifth grade with a saxophone. When I got into high school, I was a part of the band. You can be a very active member of that if you want to be. There's always opportunity to take trips. We can go to competitions. 1974, it was a big year for us because the band traveled to Ireland. A couple years before that, they were on a parade in New York, and some people from Ireland were looking for bands, you know, from the United States and other places to come for an international competition. So we were invited. They liked what they saw. They did a parade in Dublin, and then the next day they performed for competition in Limerick and won first place. And it was a pretty big thing for the town. There had been other people say, why don't you just form an alumni band? They'd been pushing me to do it, because it's hard to get people together every year. Some people live so far away. In 2011, it got big, because we started using Facebook. I think we had around 50 performers, and that wasn't just instrument players. That was silks, majorettes. We had alumni cheerleaders get involved. It was pretty eventful, a lot of stuff packed into one weekend. It's a small community, and we form relationships more easily. Everybody knows everyone. There's a hominess to the size of the town, but I like that small town feel. There's something about it that keeps us close.
Well, my name is Joyce Fry, and I'm here to talk about U.S. Envelope in Williamsburg. Back in 1963, the paper mill went from white paper to brown paper, which created a lot of unemployment. So the federal government and West Sligo were instrumental in locating the U.S. Envelope plant in Williamsburg. I worked at U.S. Envelope for 24 years, and I at first was a quality inspector and then was transferred to the office and retired from the accounting office in 1987. The machine that made the embossed stamped envelopes was called a VH machine. And there was a big roll of paper in the back of the machine which thread through, and when they come out at the other end, it was an embossed stamped envelope. These machines ran approximately 1,000 envelopes a minute. The packer had to pick one up, inspect it, and pick 500 up and flip them and put them in a box. Because it was embossed stamped envelopes, they operated like a federal mint. There were security guards there when you come in the lobby, and when you left work, they had the right to check your lunchbox or pocketbook. If a tractor trailer came in to unload, there had to be a security guard on the dock before they could unload. It's really amazing to think back, because there was like 20 office personnel. At that time, computers took up like a whole room, and the computers became into existence. At the time I retired, there were 3 office personnel. I think the best part about living in a small community is you know everybody. We were mostly local people. It was sort of like a family. You shared your family problems. You shared your wedding or your children. And we would bring covered dish lunches in to share with each other. It benefited the community a lot.
My name is Ron Scuvier, and I'm proud to say that I hail from Williamsburg. And I'm here to talk about the immigrant connection, actually a little village by the name of Gannister, which was on the outskirts of Williamsburg, and the impact that it had on the town. The original name for that settlement was Franklin Forge, and as the name implies, there really was an iron forge there. Franklin Forge was built around 1831, right there in the location that's now Gannister. And it was adjacent to the canal boat line. The village of Franklin Forge, by the early 1900s, was a little international boom town. My great-grandfather, his name was Steve Scuvier, came over to this country first in 1904. And as was frequently the case, he spent some time here and then went back. My grandfather came to this country in 1911, came initially to Williamsburg, worked actually in the paper mill for a time, then went back to Passaic, New Jersey. And that's where he met my grandmother, who had been here a few years earlier. She came in 1907 at the age of 13. And if you look at their wedding picture, they were married in 1911, they look like children. They really, really do. Located right above the quarries, there was a farm. The property had been abandoned, and my uncle was able to pull some strings, and they were able to purchase this farm of 116 acres in 1951 for something like $1,400 in back taxes. They took this farm that had been very run down and dilapidated and just whipped it into shape. To become a citizen and to own land was really the recognition of a dream. I look at Gannister as being kind of the miniature melting pot. You know, this whole thing was going on throughout the country at this time. And we think of it as just happening in big cities like New York and Chicago, but it was going on at the micro level as well. And Williamsburg and Gannister are a good example of that.
I'm Tim Van Skoik. I'm actually not a resident of Williamsburg, but I'm representing the Blair County Historical Society to talk about the local iron industry. Etna Furnace is located east of town in Catherine Township. It was the first iron furnace built in Blair County in 1809. It was located along the banks of the Juniata River, which obviously was the only form of transportation at that time, so that was how they would have shipped the iron. The Etna site is neat in that a lot of the original structures are still standing, are still in private ownership. So you really get a sense of what the iron community, the iron plantation, as sometimes it was called, would have been like when it was in operation. The iron furnace was where the refining process took place. What's usually left is just that square stone stack, but originally there would have been a lot more buildings around that. And you would have built a fire, usually a charcoal fire, inside the furnace to get it to about 3,000 degrees, and then add the iron ore and limestone, which acted as a flux to draw off the impurities. And that would heat the iron ore to a molten state. The heavy iron would settle to the bottom of the furnace and then be drawn out into what were called pigs. It would be sold then elsewhere to be made into finished products. Springfield Furnace was the third iron furnace opened in Blair County in 1815. It was operated by the Royer family, and it was maintained within their family throughout all of its operation until about 1885. And the house itself remained in the descendants of the Royers up and through the 1960s. Near Point View was another furnace, Canoe Furnace. It was built in 1837. That was by the Spang family. It's unique in that it's the only round furnace stack in the area, and one of the few probably that I'm aware of anywhere. It had the nickname of Soap Fat Furnace. The story goes, whether you believe it or not, that one of the women buying bacon at the company store there claimed that the bacon was of such poor quality that it was only good for making soap fat. And apparently that name stuck with it, and so the furnace often was referred to as Soap Fat Furnace. The iron industry was a very important part of the economy in the mid-19th century, and this area was nationally known for the iron that was produced here. It drew a lot of people to the area. It spurred the need for improved transportation through the canal and later the railroad. And of course, eventually, that improved transportation helped to bring about the end of it because you no longer needed to build the iron furnace right where the raw materials were. But certainly through the middle decades of the 19th century, it was the most important industry in this area and is responsible for the existence of a lot of communities.
My name is Dennis Pruitt, and I'm here to talk about our church, the Grace Point Community Church of God here in Williamsburg. It's located at 815 Yalla Springs Drive on the hill overlooking the city. It used to be the Blair County Children's Home. The church purchased it in 1977 and built a new sanctuary and used the 1939 section as the Christian education facilities. The worship is contemporary. We're an evangelical Pentecostal church. Youth Pastor Brian Detwaller's head of the young adults and of the teenagers, and they have their own room, which used to be the old Blair County Children's Home gym downstairs, and it has PowerPoint, the latest in music and technology that they can use for the style of worship the kids like. We also provide Little Lambs classes and many different activities, vacations, Bible school, etc. for the youth. We have an adult Sunday school, and then of course on Wednesday nights, we have classes for all ages, from adults to little kids. The summer drive-in was our youth pastor Brian Detwaller's idea, and we ordered a big movie screen, which we put up behind the church, and we subscribe to the program where you pay a fee and you can show certain Christian movies. And we do this three or four times a year in the summer, and people can come in their cars, they can turn on their radio and listen to the movie, or they can roll down their window and hear it over the speakers. Well, I'm originally from the state of Georgia. Spent my teenage years in Casper, Wyoming. I went to college in Fresno, California, where I met my wife. We went to Alaska and pastored. Then we pastored 30-something years in California, and we've been in Williamsburg now for a little over 10 years. I've lived in San Francisco and L.A. and San Diego metro, so it was really nice coming to a small town where everybody knows one another. I found this about Williamsburg: if you don't know what you're doing, somebody will tell you. So that was a different adjustment, you know, from living in a big metropolitan area. But I really enjoy it. I like the laid-back lifestyle, not having to sit in traffic jams. And as you can see, we don't even have a traffic light in town. It's great.
And that's our town, Williamsburg. A look at the Morrison's Cove community through the eyes of its residents. Support for our town, Williamsburg, comes from UPMC Altoona, Williamsburg Family Practice, providing care for the whole family, including obstetrics. Information at 832-3405. The Williamsburg Community Betterment Corporation, helping businesses in the Williamsburg area and a proud supporter of our town, Williamsburg. And from viewers like you, thank you.
Thank you.
TV station, WPSU. Here are some of the folks, the many folks who have made this entire program possible. These are the volunteers, your friends and neighbors. It's their video, their photos, their voices, their stories. They sat down with myself and Jessica Peters and told their stories. And Bill Wallace and Chris Youngkin and sat there one Saturday at the Williamsburg Public Library and shared all their stories and talked about all the great things about Williamsburg. And we watched it come alive tonight. Your dollars, your contributions right now at 1-800-245-9779. Make this all possible. Come on, Williamsburg. We know you've got that blue pirate pride and want to share it. Talk about the traditions that we've seen here tonight. And we have seen so many people step up and help celebrate Williamsburg Night. I'm Whitney Sheridan, and it has been an honor to work with so many great folks from Williamsburg. And we thank each and every person who has called in and been a part of tonight's celebration. And now we want to hear from you. Your $75 contribution gets you a copy of tonight's program on DVD, and there are some fantastic bonus features that we did not get an opportunity to share with you in tonight's broadcast, but they can be yours when you do make that contribution, or a $120 contribution. We would love to send you two copies of that DVD. It's up to you to be a part of our town Williamsburg Night here on your local PBS station, WPSU. Right, Greg?
That's right. Call right now with your pledge. This is your last opportunity to get a DVD of the show, Our Town Williamsburg, at a pledge level of $75. We'll send that to you as a thank you gift. For $120, we can send you two copies. All the DVDs include bonus footage with Dorothy Coons and a story about William Kramer. So you won't want to miss that. Call right now. Our phone volunteers are from Williamsburg. They're the people who help put the show together, and we thank them very much, but we want to thank you for your pledge at 800-245-9779. Calling in with a pledge. Actually, this person came on the website. This is from Christopher DiEugenio in memory of Gene Tate from Chris and Erica DiEugenio in Williamsburg. Thank you very much. We also heard from Carrie and Joel Loos of Williamsburg. Thank you very much for that pledge. We also heard from Bob and Dean Hamilton in memory of Junior, Hazel, and Lynn Hamilton. Also, Margaret Campbell in memory of a very special Williamsburg teacher, Debbie McCurlin, by Peggy and Terry Campbell. Thank you very much for that pledge. And also, Nancy Strayer. Nancy Strayer in memory of Alameda and Pike DiBartolone. Or that could be DiBartolone. 1-800-245-9779. Call at your pledge at 800-245-9779. It's your last opportunity tonight to show your support for WPSU and for Williamsburg. Oh, Jess?
That's right. This is your last chance to give us a call at 1-800-245-9779. It's been so much fun to read all of these names here tonight. You don't want to be the one that misses out, because chances are we have read more names than we haven't read tonight. So if your name isn't one that we have read yet, be sure to call in. This is your chance right now, and we will thank you on air like these fine people. Thanks to Karen Allmendinger of Indiana, Pennsylvania. This is in memory of grandparents Luther and Sadie Allender, Floris Miller, Aunt Mary Jane Allender, and Uncle Chiz Allender. So thank you so much for that gift of support this evening. Thanks to Gloria Tate, class of 1967, in honor of her mother, Marion Walls, class of 1948, and in memory of her sister, Diane Hoffman, class of 1968. Thank you so much for your pledge. Thanks to Guy and Jane Croyle. This is in memory of Dorothy Ray White, class of 1932, born on Cheryl Hart's farm. Thank you so much for that gift of support, and the Croyles are from Petersburg. Thank you to Amy Jo White, Wilmer and Joyce Fry family. Amy Jo is back on the phones back over there, but she was so instrumental in helping us get started. And her grandma Joyce Fry told that great story this evening, so we want to say thanks to them. Thanks to Ariane Waddington of Williamsburg and future Blue Pirates, Aiden, Parker, and Owen White. So thanks for calling in this evening. Thanks to Janet Brantner, Bill and Jen Brantner. Awesome. You're probably seeing somebody familiar back there. Brantner is right behind me. So we had a surprise person come on in here from the Brantner family. So thanks so much for your gift of support. Oh, and the Legion. The Legion did some great things for us for this show. And we have a very special gift tonight from the Specialist Chad Edmondson Memorial. They're saying thank you to the entire Williamsburg community for always supporting events sponsored by our foundation. And you know, the testimony of that particular story, I think, speaks to the spirit of this town. You're a town that pulls together in the tough times and you celebrate the great times. And we are so happy and proud to be able to provide these stories to you. Give us a call tonight to show your support for great local shows, great local programming like this at 1-800-245-9779. We are at 307 calls tonight, Williamsburg. Oh my goodness, 307 calls. I think we could get to 325. 325 calls. I know we can do it. 1-800-245-9779. Whitney, what do you think about that goal? Oh my gosh. I think that's a great idea, Jessica. 325. I think Williamsburg can do it. I know Williamsburg can do it. Williamsburg, you know you can do it. Norm and Judy Calhoun know that you can do it, Williamsburg, and thank you to the Calhouns. Also, Carolyn and Perry Clapper, thank you so much for being a part of Williamsburg Night. And Eric Treese, thank you so much for calling in from State College and being a part of Williamsburg Night. And also, Brad Norris, longtime Williamsburg resident, thank you so much for being a part of tonight's show. And here's Connie Schatzer, in honor of William Rhodes, thank you so much for calling in. And Lori and Austin Grove from Williamsburg called in. And here's, Raised on 3rd Street. This one's from, is this Joyce Drass? Hollidaysburg? Looks like it. I'm consulting with Linda Smith. Stay tuned. Just a moment. You'll hear from Linda Smith. And here's, I know I'm teasing everybody. Linda Smith's right here. Francis Speck from Williamsburg, in memory of Michael and Catherine Speck, by Francis and Melody Speck and Marissa and Shannon. Thank you so much. And now I'm going to toss it over to Greg, who has a special guest, who I just told you about.
I indeed have a special guest. This is Linda Smith, who's the superintendent of the school district down in Williamsburg. Thanks for coming tonight.
Well, thank you. We've had a great time.
Did you have fun putting this project together?
We had a blast.
So you did a story, and like you're a high school graduate of Williamsburg.
Yes, I am.
You went to school to Slippery Rock.
Yes, I did.
Came back to Williamsburg.
Yes.
And you found a home in Williamsburg.
Well, I live in Mortonsburg.
Yes. Now, in relationship to Williamsburg, is that?
About 12 miles.
Okay, that's not bad. It's a good commute.
I live on a dairy farm with my husband, Gerald.
Well, good. So no wonder you have enough strong bones and all that. No, so thank you very much for doing this. And you know, has the outpouring of support and all that surprised you tonight?
No, not at all.
Why is that?
Because we have a great little town, and we need to say thank you for putting us on the map once again.
Oh, thank you.
Because we've been on the map several times for many things, but this is really a highlight for us this evening, and you have a class act of operation here at WPSU.
Yeah.
And all of the people that are here are very proud and have really a lot of connections in town. And we just really thank you a lot.
Well, thank you.
And I know there's more than one team in Williamsburg besides the football team.
Sure.
The volleyball team, the junior high football team, the track and field team, cross country. And I know that the football team is playing tomorrow night, but so are all the other teams. And you know, Mrs. Smith has to say, go blue.
That's right, go blue. And what else do you say? What do you want the viewers to do?
I want the viewers to pledge. That's well, what I want.
What to number play. Do they call?
1-800-245-9779.
And you said you couldn't do this.
I'm a shy person.
Yeah, sure, and I'm short. Thank you very much, Linda.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Jess?
I love it. Thanks, Linda. Linda was such a big, huge help, and we have some folks here to thank that have also been a help tonight. Thanks to Mary Estep. This is in memory of her husband, Philip Estep, from your family. Thank you so much for that gift. Thanks to Don and Grace Suter of Langhorne, right outside of Philly. Thanks for tuning in on WPSU.org tonight and making your gift of support. And another person who was a huge help for this project, Lou Jean Shelley. Thank you for your pledge of support. She was just walking behind me there. Lou Jean let us invade her library for 16 hours one Saturday, and she couldn't have provided better hospitality. We so appreciate the space. The stories look beautiful, and Williamsburg, you have a great facility in that public library. Please go take advantage of it. And there's still time tonight to take advantage of giving us a call. It is very quiet right now. And we want you to give us a call, 1-800-245-9779. Whitney? That's right. And when they do call in, when you call in at 1-800-245-9779, it is a little quiet. We would love to send you a copy of Our Town Williamsburg, the DVD, complete with some great bonus features, including a longer look at Miss Dorothy Kuntz, 92 and fabulous. Because, you know, Cheryl Hughes and Rebecca Smith are putting together this great film about Dorothy Kuntz, and there's more to see, plus a great little piece on William Kramer, because his cousin Bob Kramer sent some great Williamsburg legacy heritage newsletters to us, and we wanted to make sure that we put a feature together on that. And there are some of the trailers to the show as well, some bonus features that we're not able to show you tonight. So that can be yours when you make a contribution of $75, 1-800-245-9779, or two of those DVDs for $120. We want to make sure to thank every single person tonight. And here's one from Bobby J. Fry. And Nancy J. Brewer is her sister. And they are the third set of twins to graduate from Williamsburg. Only the third set of twins ever to graduate. So thank you, Bobby J. Fry, for calling in. And this is from Jim Grazier from Tyrone. Thank you, Mr. Grazier. And also, Dave Showers from Bowlesburg says hi to George Dempsey from Dave and Diane Showers. And also, Connie and Daryl Brumbaugh from Williamsburg. And it is a little quiet, so now is a great time to call. 1-800-245-9779. Greg?
We have 319 pledges in. Nice round number. We'd like to get to 325, which would match the number of years the town's been incorporated. I don't know. What's it? 225. Plus 100. So let's get to 325. So six of you call right now at 800-245-9779 and make your pledge. Thank you to Jerome Conlin of Roaring Spring. Wants a shout out to Tim Tate, the greatest teacher ever. All right. I just read them, okay? David and Sharon Snyder of Lloydsburg, in memory of Lila McGray of Morrison Cove, correspondent for many years. Also, Irene Coote, who works at Penn State and lives in Osceola Mills. Class of 1971, sister of Ron Scavere, in memory of parents and grandparents. So thank you very much. And renewing her membership. Thank you very much, Irene. Ron Robeson of Altoona called in a pledge. And wait a second. We also heard from Richard and Dawn Hoover in memory of Glenn Hoover. So thank you very much for those pledges. Six more. We'll get to 325, and we'll call it macaroni. 1-800-245-9779. Jess?
Six more. How about 10 more?
10 more.
I mean, wait a minute. Back here. We have nine phones back
nine
here.
More.
We have eight phones open. Why not fill up all eight phones? There are eight families out there that we know haven't called in. And if you're watching and you did make your pledge, call those people. I mean, what time is it here? It is what? It's only 10:54. They're still awake. Give them a call. And then have them call us at 1-800-245-9779. We do want to give a special shout out to Otto's tonight for giving us some delicious pizza to enjoy. It was very wonderful. Keep our volunteers energized, and they needed it back here. Now remember that with your gift of support of $75 on that DVD, you're going to get some bonus features. You're going to be able to see Dorothy Kuntz and talk a little bit more about what she's been up to in her very, very fabulous life. Bill Kramer and what he meant to the community, as well as those two little trailers that you have been seeing that have been running on WPSU to promote this show. That's just some of the extras, just a little extra way of us saying thanks for your gift of support for WPSU and programs like this. I do want to make sure to thank Sharon Mummert Wagner of Dysart, and this is in memory of Faith and George Mummert. So thank you so much for that gift of support. Okay, so we have two people on the phone now. That means we have seven more families. Wake them up. 1-800-245-9779. Whitney? That's right. Wake them up. It's Thursday, but is Thursday the new Friday? I think so, especially when it's Williamsburg night. Come on, you guys are getting ready for that Blue Pirate Pride, right? Come on. I know you're celebrating. And what better way to celebrate, especially the spirit of your community, by supporting stories from your community right now at 1-800-245-9779. Make a contribution of $75 and we would love to send you a copy of Our Town Williamsburg, the DVD, something that you'll want to share for so many years. It's like a great time capsule of all these stories. And there's so those bonus features that we've been talking about, $120 contribution, and two of those DVDs will come your way. Our way of saying thanks for your support of programs here on your public television station, WPSU, 1-800-245-9779 or online at WPSU.org. So many great stories have come your way tonight, courtesy of your contributions, courtesy of all your friends and neighbors in Williamsburg. And I want to move over here and say thanks to all my friends from Williamsburg who have made this possible. Anonymous in honor of Elma Ayers and Anna and Blair Crownover. Mm-hmm. And also Rod Imler. Thank you so much. Thank you so much to everyone who has called in and been a part of Williamsburg Night here on WPSU. And thanks for your support. Go Blue Pirates.
Go Blue Pirates.
Go Pirates.
And everybody.
Thanks to the wonderful people here in the studio tonight.
And everybody who told their stories and collected all the photos and videos to make this show possible. And all the support from the town, of course. Right. Thanks so much, Williamsburg. Have a great evening.
1-800-245-9779.
That's right. And go Blue Pirates.
That's it. Thanks a lot. Thanks for tuning in tonight. Good night.
You can also make your pledge at WPSU.org. Click on Contribute at the top of the page. It's always available and easy to use. Thanks.